Okay, stays offline for now.
Oh, it says you're online. Let's see if
Oh,
it,
it's
let's see if I
working.
get a feed. Oh no, I think that's just maybe that's just like you're online on Twitch. I don't
No.
mind. Let's see if
Oh, it's
it. I
working.
don't
If I
really know
get
how
it.
Twitch works.
Okay, it's working. It's working. It's live.
It's still working. It's live. All right, maybe I have to. You know, I'll open it. I was gonna open it up on my
What's
I was
this
opening it up
stream?
on my phone. Sorry, what was that?
No, go on. Try again. See
Okay,
if I'm actually
I was just
online.
saying I was opening it up on my phone, but it did not enjoy that.
Oh, I see. I see.
I would like the Twitch app is kind of it's not great, I think. We'll open it up on here. It's not saying you're online yet, but maybe it'll take a second to let me click on your channel and see. Let's see. It says you're offline for now. Maybe it's just gonna maybe you have like a little bit of a delay, I don't know. Maybe I have a little. Oh no, you're online now. You just went online.
Hey, cool. Okay. Might as well just leave this rolling then.
Yeah. Let me just make sure I can like hear like sound and everything for you. Might as well test it while we're here.
Might as well. Does it sound
Yeah.
okay on you? Does you
It's
do you sound fine?
buffering. It's buffering.
Yeah, let me know.
Wait, I
Testing,
don't.
testing,
No, it's good.
testing.
It's good.
It's good. Quality's
It's good.
good. You sound
Yeah.
good. I sound good.
Yeah. Yes.
Good.
Like similar audio levels. It's not like that last video I had with you.
When I was just
That
like
was just
obnoxiously
so
loud.
bad. Yeah. Nah, this is fine. I turned you down to normal. It should also be fine.
Great. Wonderful.
I'll put you up.
Looks
Turn
like the
you up to
contestants are ready.
100%. These guys are ready. Let me go to this. Probably shouldn't have coughed like that. All right, I will start recording. Let me get a sip of water. Three, two, one, go. Oh, no, don't go there. Three, two, one, go. Hello, everyone. This is CPAT bringing you another Exceed commentary. And today, we've reached the finals, Mego, haven't we? We have Mego, by the way, online. We've reached the
Hello.
finals of this tournament that we've been basically, you and I have been casting for the past 6, 7 weeks.
Yeah, pretty
Something like
much.
that.
Pretty
Yeah, we
much.
have the finals. It's a rematch of the last one. I think these two guys have comprehensively proven that they're the best two, they're the two best players in Exceed right now, right? I think we can
Probably.
claim that.
Yeah, it's a good claim to make.
Seeing how, yeah, Calavantis is like undefeated, and Mix has only lost to Calavantis.
Oh yeah, in pools.
Mix, yeah, so in the, oh,
Swiss.
in this tournament he's lost once, and in the last tournament he's lost twice, but they are the best. Did you tell them that they're good to go? All right, I'll
Oh,
just put it
well,
in the
whoops.
chat.
Yeah,
We're
I
doing
mean,
it live. Probably should have started this video a minute later than I did, but
it makes sense that he's bringing out bank here. Calvontis thinks Umna versus Zolt is awful, which makes sense.
yes,
Because
and not only
Umna
that,
is the...
he thinks that Umna versus Hakumen is very good for Umna.
Oh.
Yes, I was
Well,
talking to him about this yesterday. He thinks Umna Hakumen is super Umna favorite, so he wants to save Umna for that matchup.
yeah, I think Umna will do well against slow characters.
Yeah, coin flip. We got heads. No, nothing in the chat. That's okay. Last time I saw this matchup, this was the most impressive bang game I'd ever seen.
Oh yeah,
It
but
was,
it was
I,
a steamroll for sure. But
yes,
at the
I,
same
everything
time,
went right, but still, like it was just like, dude, it was bang.exe. As looks like Zolt's going second, bang with the turn one bang prep makes sense to me. I mean,
I mean, but Mix should be on his A game today, so it would not. I don't
should
think
be.
it'll be a steamroll this time.
I mean, both these players have been practiced. Did you actually ca catch the mixed practice games or no?
No, I don't even know he was practicing. I saw he had a room
Oh,
up. That's it.
I see. Yeah, I saw the Calvontis practice games. I won't leak anything. Check out the next video, though. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, imagine how scummy it would be if I recorded
Yeah, and
it.
then you
Cease.
send it to Mix, the exchange forum.
No, don't send it to Vix. Post it on the YouTube for the content as we see spike boosts on both sides here. Grass coming out from Bang.
Yeah, Bang's just setting up a safe payout attack. It makes sense.
Like strikes into this. Think he'd go for like a cheeky cross up here? Get that transformed early? Or like a normal cross?
Don't
Which would be
think.
safer.
I think cross up makes a lot of sense here. I mean, Bang does have DPs, so he can just go for it, unless Bang has an EX normal.
EX cross or EX bank style.
Yeah, I mean, that'll be the only thing that'll stop cross up, really.
I wonder if Calvontis goes for. Oh, that's an EX.
That's a bit worrying.
Oh no.
Well,
Luckily it was
it
just
was just
crossed.
regular cross. Yeah,
Yeah.
it wasn't a cross up.
So that'll be 5 damage coming in, 3, 4 from EX cross, plus the 2 power, and Nyx had 1 armor. So still takes 5. Bank to the corner, bank prep again. Reach 4 means bank style shuriken is a big thing.
Yeah, Bang loves crossing out just to enforce Shurikenkid, make it super safe.
Yeah, Zolt does have that speed 5 at range 4, but in the face of Bank Style Shuriken, that's tough to play. Especially with that transform on it. You don't want to lose those in combat.
I mean, Zolt can just play Gunblaze and he's fine.
Yeah, true.
Gunblaze doesn't even necessarily need to hit. He still gets to draw two cards if he doesn't hit, because this is before.
Second spike coming out early from Calvontis here.
Just boosting normals. Makes sense.
Seems fine.
Doesn't want to get red.
Oh, we like to point out when two copies of a card are used super early, but Spike's not a super relevant card in Banks, in Calvontis's Banks kit, I think.
Yeah, Calvontis is not a spike player, like I am.
Like I am
Okay,
as well. Text?
this seems like a waiting move. Not really. I mean, Bang doesn't have many continuous boosts to speak of, really. They're mostly
That's
instant
cool.
and just now strike boosts.
Zoom in on Bank's kit here real quick. Make sure you zoom in on Bank's kit for the stream, Migo.
Yeah, I mean, the only continuous boost that are annoying from Bang's side is
Set nail.
Sentinel is annoying to play around. That's really it. Others are just instant boosts, or Larger Than Life is good, but eh.
Larger than life is something I saw Calvontis boost before. He actually did it backwards. Like normally the combo is Bank Style Shuriken into larger than life, but I've seen him do it backwards. So the boost first and then into the Bank Style Shuriken.
Interesting to see here that Calvontis prep bank prepping with s seven cards, so he's forced to draw down, discard down,
This card's two, yeah.
and he also tossed away a Pulverizing Blast when he did a bank prep. So he's probably just digging for Shuriken very hard,
Yeah.
because
Parry cross up
values the
early.
cards massively.
Calvontis is either parrying cross up or whip crack. Those are the two he goes for normally. Although I did see him parry a Blaze of Fervor once, but
Now
no, it gets the cross up.
cross up makes. I mean, cross up is Zolt's most valuable transform because it's his economy.
Yeah, we say it every single time. Check out the last 5 Zolt videos.
Calvontis taught me to fight against Zolt. He said, "Parry cross up.
There you
Always parry
go.
that card because that
There
card
you go.
is a
He
bitch."
actually parries Whipcrack early as well though.
Yeah, I mean, whip, I mean, plus one speed when initiating is also very strong. Those two are his best ones.
Yeah, parry the transforms for sure though. Like
Guy in chat saying,
EX.
"Calvontis, my boy, fuck him up good."
Good. Good. Great. We're like 10 minutes into the video, so we'll still get our monetization off it.
Yeah.
EX in response. EX Bank Style Shuriken will probably beat out anything. Oh, EX Focus. Interesting.
Yeah, that is a pretty interesting choice. But hey, I mean, it's very safe here. Bang can't ever he can Bank can't actually avoid this focus here since he's cornered. There's nothing Bank can boost that will stop him from getting hit by focus.
you think this was like a bait in like Zolt was like posturing to play something like EX Assault
Yeah, it could. I mean,
at speed six, which is on curve.
yeah, well, it forces Bang to play the EX just to,
Yes.
as a response. It makes sense.
Actually, the order on that is the same. Like he can Calvados can choose what card goes on top.
And
Doesn't matter.
yeah, and then
But
Calvin is choosing not to boost, just taking the card engage.
Next, moving back to range three with the often forgotten front side Zolt ability.
If you're a good Zol player, you don't forget it. It's really good, though.
Yes, I'm not a good Zolt player, so I forget it.
Oh, well, there you go.
Yeah, there you go.
Zol grass beats
Another bang
sweeps,
prep.
so.
EX Transform Whipcrack.
Nice.
Zolt now only needs three gauge to exceed. Maybe we should have like a little bar on how much gauge Zolt needs to exceed for the next tournament. We'll upgrade the UI that way. My
Yeah.
apologies. We're downgrading to 720p for this video because my last 1080p, my laptop did not enjoy that.
Oh, I'm recording this in crisp 1080p.
Oh, you always gotta one up me. Are you affiliate though on
Twitch
Twitch?
affiliate? No, I don't stream,
Oh.
barely.
But you can get affiliate mad easily, right? I don't even. I feel like it's like three viewers or something. It's like Calvados is gearing up for an EX attack. You saw him move that fifth card to the second one.
Looks like it,
Oh,
perhaps.
but then now boosting with it. Shuffle your hand, Calvados. No! Boosting Void Tempest Kick. You think that leftmost card is Void Tempest Kick in his hand? I hope not.
I don't know. I don't see Calvin just ever playing Void Tempest Kick, to be honest. Not gonna lie. He just doesn't value his attack. He'd rather just boost it.
Gets teched. So Void Tempest Kick. Pretty easy to get engaged if you boost it. A little bit tough, a little bit more risky as an attack.
What type of kick with spike boost is very good though.
Second Void Tempest Kick getting boosted. Did that come from the leftmost side? I don't know. But it's why you shuffle your hand, folks.
Yeah. Cool. Just wants to confirm the hit. Could just be a simple grasp. Will do.
Really sweep in response or something, right? As well, both Void
No,
Tempest
palm
Kicks
thrust
are
actually
down.
makes sense as well. Grasp. Okay.
Pump Thrust only pushes two, right? So sweep would hit back.
It would.
Nope, just the block. The four power grass coming in.
Think Mix was thinking about pitching away to grasp to for force.
Surely pitch something away, I think.
Yeah. You kind of, every point of life is important.
Well, now that you've shown the grasp, you have to pitch it away.
Yeah, you've leaked hand info already.
Yeah, you have to pitch it away.
Might see an early XC from Bang here.
Yeah,
He
just a
has
reminder.
three EX. He has all four of them are can be EX'd because they're all in discard.
Bang cross grass was boosted earlier and Void Tempest Kick was also boosted. Yep, correct.
Yeah.
Four EXs on the ready. And a lot of, or I shouldn't say a lot of, what I used to think was that you have to exceed with the four specials in to get full value, but Bang gets enough, more than enough value with getting anything back, right? Getting those EXs back doesn't really matter what you get back.
Yeah, I mean, Hyper Shadow Step is just a bonus.
Yeah, it's a bonus, but it's not core to his kit. He doesn't need it to win in games,
No.
which is what I mistakenly thought. Like, or maybe I just wanted to hit with it because it does a billion damage.
I mean, first,
Prep, prep.
that's always the first impression, Bang, when you look at it, be like, oh, he plays for this all the time. But he doesn't.
Rage 1 speed.
Oh, yes. One guy in chat says Calvin is undefeated. He is undefeated in tournaments.
Except he did lose one game to you.
Yes, I did take one game off of him.
That's the only game I think Calvontis has lost in this tournament. He lost several games to Mix in the last one. Games, not matches.
Correct. Yeah.
I don't know the history of these players before Jungies, Japes, the original.
But yes, other than fighting me, he's just been clean 2-0s from him.
That you should have put that in your stream title. Like, oh, only player to ever be Calavantis ever commentate succeed match
Clickbait.
with local scrub friends.
Yomi player.
Yo, with you, with dirty Yomi player. Plus two speed. Last time I saw Calavantis boost plus two speed at range one, he went for assault into exceed.
It makes a lot. I think that's the sequence he's setting up. Yeah, actually, that's I see Calvin to do it almost all the time, actually.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he always prepares to assault before he exceeds.
Power and response. This is the appropriate response to that threat.
Yeah, I mean, Bang has no crosses, no Void Tempest kicks, so you can just okay. If you want to hit me, I'll trade with you.
Yeah.
Go ahead. And Zol just needs one more gauge to exceed.
One more gauge ship. That's why we need that bar at the bottom, the Zolt bar.
Zol bar.
I mean, it'd be cool if we could get like some UI stuff.
I mean,
Enhance the experience. How do you turn off the UI? Do you know? I'm gonna do that for the video, but I don't know how. Also, I'm gonna cut that part out for the video so I don't tell them.
how do you mean you talk
I
about
don't, you know, I'm not gonna hit random buttons because I might accidentally close the room and I am the host.
I don't know how to
There is a
hide
way.
TTS stuff, but I'm not gonna
Yeah,
mess
there's
around
a
with that.
way. That's okay. I did it before, I think. I did it in one of my videos as well. I did it for like a brief second. I think I did it accidentally though. There's a way to like hide all these buttons. As these guys are actually taking their time. So in the last match we saw, which was just a pools match, which didn't really have any stakes attached to it, because they were both going to make playoffs, they were speed demoning through their set. This set seems a lot slower. Also, to be fair, I guess Calavantis doesn't have incredibly obvious bang plays to make. Or I guess incredibly obvious to him because he's played the character so much.
Yeah, Calvolt is actually taking his time here. Might as well, no timer, so.
No timers. Last time, the first ever Exceed match I casted had that timer controversy. The timers were stated. That was fun. That was fun because I got to spin a narrative that was like way bigger than it actually was, but I enjoyed it.
Yeah, of
Because
course you did.
both these guys can play fast. Obviously, they're the best two Exceed players, and yeah, they know their characters in and out. They can play fast. Looks like a set nail coming out from Bang. So this is threatening like retreat to into like a spike mix-up in theory. No, not spikes. Spikes are down. So
Spikes
what
are
is this
down.
threatening? Dive?
Dive, yeah.
To dodge the slow?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not too sure if, what's the
Well,
purpose of the set
it's not, it
nail.
surely it's not like advance two into like a range one move, right? That doesn't make sense,
Yeah,
cornering
he's using
yourself.
it for the, I guess the trend, just the
It's
transitor trade.
threatening to it's it has to be threatening dive. There's nothing else to threaten, really. And you just
It's
want
the
to
only
you
thing that makes sense if you want to deal
yeah.
with a plus two
Well,
power.
yeah, I mean, given if our observation that mix plays a slow into this mix up is correct, then yeah, he's threatening to dive. We'll take a look at the set nail boost before you may advance or retreat too. So Bang would be able to come back to the center and then dive over a slow. Looks like mix plays into it, interestingly enough. Mix, the only thing that beats dive as far as speed is concerned would be I. There's two of
Yeah.
them left.
Seems odd to play an eye before you exceed, though.
Yeah.
I don't think you do it
It's
usually.
frisky. It's frisky.
Sometimes you do if you really want to be an option, but otherwise you save the eyes for.
Waltzwing, last card known. Oh, okay.
Oh, sick. Yeah, last
Yeah,
card was,
dodges
yeah.
it.
Sick play, actually.
So we can look at Fatal Eruption here. Push 8, close 4, draw 1. It has a speed 7 dodge. That would also trade with I.
Yes, and we'll beat sweep very cleanly.
Yes. There you
Of course, Bang doesn't look like Bang's gonna exceed now because he's not gonna get
Yeah,
Yahtzees.
the reshuffle is a little unfortunate.
But you know, Bang just wants to win the combat. He doesn't want to give his altered gauge, doesn't want to eat 8 damage.
Exactly.
It's well worth it to do that. Yeah, that play was sick, actually, because
Were there
the before
no
I didn't
dives
think of
left?
it. Maybe there was no dives, but I mean,
I guess this beats both sides of the mix-up, so it doesn't really matter. And maybe you want to beat both sides of the mix-up anyway, even if it's at the cost of reshuffling. And hey, technically still has EX Fatal Eruption available when he exceeds. Just needs that fifth gauge, right?
yeah, EXP Eruption can be.
That's a thing. It's cheap. It's cheap. It does like 8 damage, right?
It's a decent ultra for 1 gauge. It's just like a special on steroids, that kind of stat line. So Bang's
Kalvan's
strategy
distracting
here
here from range 4.
is
Did draw one card off the top.
Jutsu dive or Shuriken. Oh,
Bait.
that was a bait.
And well, that was is a bait, but it was he that was the one card that he drew off the top was the cross. Now it gets in the discard, so that exceed becomes a little bit better.
Yeah, it was a bait and also set up EX Cross. Yeah, that makes sense. 100%. Hind reflexes, we want to take another action. Probably just
Thinking about
playing.
this, Blaze.
It's probably Blaze. 100%. It's on curve, it negates advantage. Yeah.
Bang will take 5. So it moves to the corner, gets that second transform,
Takes
so
four,
that
but yeah.
exceed only costs 1. Was Bang at 26?
Yeah,
Yeah,
he
okay.
corrected it already just
Okay.
now.
Yeah, surely this is the exceed action coming out right away. Yep, there is Hunter of Men. Take a look at this bad boy here.
Oh, hey, thanks for the follow, Ashy the Great. I don't stream much, but you know,
Yeah, thanks
maybe
for the
I'll
follow,
stream and see.
Ashy. Where's my sub? Ashy, huh? Just kidding. Thank you for subbing too, or following me. I hate how the verbs are different for all the different medias,
The verb,
Confuses me.
you mean for different media
Yeah, like a
platforms?
sub on YouTube is free versus a sub on Twitch is paying money.
Yeah, I see. I get what you mean. It's confusing.
Confusing. Who do you think's winning right now? Zolt is looking pretty good, honestly. Just doesn't have that cross-up transformed. But the thing about exceeded Zolt is that you can just hit with cross-up later, and then you get it transformed like this turn.
Yep. Yeah, I don't know why Zolt can hit transformations while he's chaining attacks, but you know. Fair and balanced.
Fair and balanced.
I love seeing Zolt play Evil Fatal Eye into Blaze of Fervor and just get it transformed for free. Really cool.
Yeah.
But I would say this
Even
game
worse
stays
is
pretty.
Whipcrack, because Whipcrack gives you the, if you have advantage already with the eye, Whipcrack gives you like
That gives you
really
positioning.
good positioning. Yeah. You get to choose your range basically. How about opting for the normal prep? Looking at his deck, he's kind of low on cards. Not sure if that's going to play a factor, but
Can
Bang
he?
Prep does use 3 cards.
Hopefully, he can kill him fast enough. Maybe he can. I mean,
Makes
Bang
sense there.
can, but it's
Yeah, Bang
just
can.
because of his recur of his card recursion when he overdrives.
Bang can. Problem is, Zolt can, in theory, steal advantage back. Focus coming out. Reading.
This focus is quite likely to hit. Yeah,
Yeah.
nice.
I believe both assaults are left in the deck. So yeah,
Assault
perfect
Pop
call out
Approach,
there.
yes, giving advantage, and he can. Oh, preps first. Doesn't exceed right away.
Doesn't exceed right away. Giving Zolt time, in theory. But Zolt only has 5 cards in hand and no cross-up transformed.
Okay, we're just looking
Speed.
for speed. Makes sense.
Mix boosts it back. Down to one card in deck, seven in hand, so hand information is pretty much known. Parry will be second cross up, I'm assuming.
No,
No,
he's pairing to
BI.
Fiddleye.
BI, okay.
You're definitely pairing any Fiddleye Thistle
Yes.
has.
Oh, yeah.
I think Bang has the upper hand. Bang can definitely has the capability of killing Zolt before he even gets into seeing red range.
And is known.
Think both focuses are down for Bang, or just one? I'm not sure.
Just one.
Oh, so this is kind of risky.
Yeah, second reading assault could
Well,
actually be
Sol
in
has the
theory.
defend boosted, so actually it seems like he's not concerned about reading.
I guess with EX
With spike boosted, you're
Unstoppable
not really
Palm Thrust
concerned.
down, it's kind of tough to super punish an assault here, right? I mean, he's gonna do
He's gonna
it.
do it right
Maybe
now.
there is, yeah, maybe there is a.
Oh, just
Oh, the
block.
block. Okay.
Okay, wants to get pulverizing into gauge. I see. Oh, he can play for Hyper Shadow Step now.
Do all four? Does. Good call up.
Okay, I see his plan here. Yeah. Overdrive into Hyper Shadow and both blocks are down, so block is really the only thing to stop Hyper Shadow, so
Did Mix take three there?
Mix took, he only took one.
No, now he's taking, deciding to only take one. Okay.
Okay, I see. I think he wants to block for the reshuffle. Because Hyper Shadow Step is coming. Actually, it's really bad for Zolt.
If there's no way to
Because the
like
block is
take
stuck
a,
in gauge. I
if
mean,
there's,
he might
if
change cards
yeah,
here, but block
well, if
is.
there's no way to advantage into death, which I don't think there is, yeah, this is trouble. I like that Calvados is setting it up.
Yeah, I mean it's fairly obvious. Is it that
No,
he's not
no,
giving
buddy.
anything away with
That's a
that?
mind game right there. That's a mind game right there.
Well, you think he's not gonna go? He's gonna then later like put the
No,
cross
no,
over
no. It's just like, hey, guess what? This is coming. Like, obviously, both players know that it's coming because they're like the best players in the game. But lining it up like that, it's just a power move, you know?
there.
It's not. It's purely a psychological thing. It's not a. I mean, it doesn't give any information, but just lining it up like that—that's a power move.
Makes sense.
Mix could like eye into cross up, and then like in theory be set.
Kind of. Not really though, because Hyper Shadow Step hits full board.
No, but I'm saying he doesn't give Calvontis another turn.
He's not gonna have enough
Yeah,
economy to
that's
do
the
that.
thing.
He's gonna hit him once or
It's
twice and then he's done.
unlikely. It's unlikely that he has enough.
I don't know if you go for the eye anyway. Maybe you do.
Can go for eye cross up and change cards your whole hand and the gauge, maybe.
Yeah, I can see that.
Did he have? I think in an ultra left, so it'd be a change cards four, drawing five. I mean, change cards three, drawing four. Because he has to spend a force to get the cross up transformed.
He has Wall Hunt in hand, yeah. I don't know what line Mix has right now. Probably just try and get cross up transformed, yeah.
Oh,
Does he validate this? Maybe not. Unless he wants to add something specifically.
I don't think you validate this because I don't think you want the Gunblaze to
Oh.
be able to draw the two cards.
Oh, actually, min having it miss is
Yeah.
not bad.
Yeah, no, it's really good.
That's funny. Yeah, you don't want him to get more cards. Makes
Yeah,
sense.
no, that's actually super good. Like, Gunblaze only does three damage and Zolt doesn't get to draw two cards off it. That's great.
And he is safe from evil eye right now. Yeah, I think he's just gonna go for it. Oh, okay. He spent one force from Gage to put both blocks in his discard, so he hopes that he gets it right here.
Yes. Focus will
And, you know,
mitigate some damage.
mitigates a little bit.
And Zol gets a turn now with 9 health, which is better than 7 health, I guess. Only 3 cards in hand is sketch. Does still have the eye. Has eye assault and I don't remember the third card.
Wild Hunt.
Oh, Wild Hunt. Which one is Wild Hunt again? That's the one that's like goes across the board.
That's the eye. He just wants to be safe from Infinite Chaos Fist. Because I think Bang is the second one.
I think we've only seen one, yeah. That makes sense to me.
Shuriken here. Why? Do you favor just to beat out a cheeky assault?
Well, yeah, but now Mix plays the assault gear now, right? I guess he has to put plus one speed on it, probably. I bet Shuriken will probably return to hand
Oh, he just wants to put in discard. There we
if
go.
Bang gets a
He just want
turn.
to get a. He just want to put in discard.
Yeah, and you get card draw out of it as well.
No, you don't. It's before.
Oh, is it before? Oh, okay.
It's not. It's not on reveal.
Well,
Oh, he had another one. That is free because you know his overdrive is full. That was
yeah.
sick. Okay, well, it's game over.
I mean, I think Mix just took that as a bet, and
Yeah, just wanted to, you know.
yeah, and there's only a 25% chance he had in hand, right? 2 cards in hand, 6 in deck.
Yeah, but of course Bang will filter. Well, I'll filter for it with Bang Prep, you know.
But I don't know if he's holding in his hand the entire time, you know. But yeah, basically, yeah, just went for the bet, did not pay out. Mix definitely needed a bet there because he was just too low on life.
He was incredibly behind. He had to go for something.
Yeah,
Just
and
went.
not only that, he didn't have a ton of. I guess he had enough advantage chain options in his deck. They only had 2 cards in hand, so pretty likely that they weren't even in his hand. Had to go for the assault.
That finish was super sick. He's like, once the eye
Yeah,
was
that
down,
was
he's
sick.
like, oh, I can play this for free now.
That was sick. He actually had it, yeah.
Yeah. That was sick. Game one goes to Calvontis.
Here comes the Umina. No, Kokonoe. Maybe the thumbnail for the video. I'll just put an X through Kokonoe.
Yeah.
It's like a giant red X. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, Calvontis' team is two characters.
Yeah, it's weird how the tournament's not best of five.
Yeah, I think it's a bit strange too for the finals at least, but oh well.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I don't know which is weirder, like the rules of the last one, which was best of five, but you can play a character twice and win with it, or this one, which is best of three. I don't know which one. I don't know which format I like worse or dislike more.
Think being able to pick the same character again that you want with is dumb, but
And this
that's.
is also the plan for Calvontis is coming to fruition, because if Zolt wins this game, then he gets the either forces Umina in or either forces Umina Hakumen, which is a matchup that Calvontis really likes, or forces the Plague Knight, turn one EX transform. At
Good
least it's only
start.
Blaze of Fervor, but great start. Yeah. Sweep in the Dreamlands. We can take a look at Dreamlands here real quick on front side. You can strike with the card and then
Oh,
ooh,
great
that's
start.
big. That's big.
Yeah, Dark
EX
Tots
transform Dark
is Dark
Thoughts.
Tots is Umina's best transform.
Take a look at that.
In case you forget what it does, it just makes the copies of a card in Dreamlands invalid for the opponent. So they cannot play as a strike, they cannot boost it.
Yeah. On top of that, Umina has ways to yoink cards from her opponent, so she can yoink something like an eye, and that would be like huge. Yeah, pretty good start for both players here.
Yeah, they got the EX Transform Season 2, baby.
Season 2 early game draw variants. Let's go.
Hell yeah.
Spike boost into a prep.
At least it can be used as force.
At least what can be used as force?
The cards that are invalid. Sweeps, in this
Oh,
case.
yes. Yeah.
Is the best way to use them when they're, or else they're dead in your hand. Yeah, Zolt can play the range 2 game versus Umina. Be very good for him. Because
Rage one a
range
little
2.
bit worse.
Because
He
Hollow
has all moves back to range two.
Wow, Hollow Space.
Take a look at this card, real quick. This bad boy, this powerhouse of a card.
Hollow Space kind of lo loses to. Loses to. What's the card? Gunblaze, though.
Yes.
Zolt has answers.
Little bit of a dance here.
I mean, Umina's fine with this, just walking him into the corner. Well,
Yeah.
Zolt can get out of the corner pretty easily,
And then
though.
cross up. Yeah. Nice.
Shadow Course doesn't need
Moves back again.
What is this gameplay? This is what happens when you, season 2 happens, you
This is
know.
season two at its best.
Yep. It's like I don't want him to hit a particular transform, so I'm gonna.
Oh no. Second transform, whip crack.
Parry
Parry
cross up.
cross up.
There we
Yep.
go. Season 2 gameplay.
We have two robots play the early game and look this exactly the same.
Oh, jeez.
Surely mix doesn't do a thing of like spending an ultra and a second card to move out of the corner, right? It's too expensive. Yeah, no, he doesn't. Nope, just runs out instead.
Yep, pretty good. Pretty good cross.
Yeah, don't think Yumina is happy playing the same game of inching closer to Zolt now. I think she was happier before than she is now.
Yeah, it's because, you know, it's all called the EX transform and suddenly things change.
Although EX trans cross-up cannot be EX transformed anymore, at least. Surely this gets ended by like a reading soon or something like that. This little song and dance. Nope, not yet.
Continue staking to range 1. I mean, there's one less cross to worry about. Umna's happy with that. She just wants to hit you hard.
Both players down to 13 cards in deck, so
Both players
hand
halfway through the
information
deck, no
is,
damage. Yep.
yeah, hand information is starting to become a thing slowly. Maybe a couple more movement turns before.
I'm pretty sure I've seen a game before. I think I it was in casual something, but Calvante Zoomina was involved, and then another season 2 character. And I think they were like almost through the decks, and they just haven't damaged each other at all. Like they had like
Good.
both like 10 cards left. It's like, oh my
This
god,
is the
season
high
2.
quality gameplay that
Season 2 Never
we paid
Strike.
for. I paid for it recently. I bought the season
Bought the
two. I
season 2,
bought all.
yeah?
Yeah, I bought season two. I paid for this gameplay recently, folks. $39.99 plus tax on level99games.com. There you go. That's a free one for you guys there.
Nice ad.
Yeah. Okay.
Sick.
Threatening
Zolt's just
battle
saying, please strike
instinct.
me now.
Yeah, please strike me. Yep. Because if Umina does not strike, Zolt gets a free exceed.
Stick's
Sorry,
actually a
tilting
really
it.
sick boost.
It's very good. A please strike me now boost is very good. Yeah.
Don't think it's like broken either. It just forces you to
No,
do
it's
some,
not.
just forces the opponent to do something,
Yeah.
which can be very valuable. Instead of forces the opponent to do something other than, you know, striking.
Yeah, exactly. Or forces them to strike, yeah.
Force that to strike.
But
Whoops. Come on, Galvantis. First blood. Come on.
first blood. It's not first blood. Range one hollow space, let's see it. Who needs hits in this game? Season two, baby.
I mean, that's the problem for Umina. I was like, she would much rather.
Looks like he's looking for a reading actually. 12 in deck, 5 in hand is a little sketch, but
There's two copies of the normal.
maybe
Maybe
you
you go
just
for
go,
it.
maybe you just go for it anyway, and like you play a combat card that like wins a lot, so it's fine. Something like a read cross into hall space or something like that. Just like a good solid combat win that can be like guaranteed, but it's still fine without the focus.
Game's not looking good for Umina though, I think.
Sold two transforms out,
Yeah,
no
Zolt with two
damage done.
transforms and you haven't done
Looking
any
pretty good for
damage to him.
Zolt, yeah.
Yeah,
Yeah,
it's
looking pretty good
Zolt's
for
winning
Zolt.
by default.
And Umina can do a ton of damage in relatively short bursts with cards like Unknown Kadath, but okay, there's the reading.
Don't think it's gonna be successful.
Yeah, it's whiffs.
Oh, three normals in
So
hand.
what? It wasn't the cross. Or maybe like reading, you could like not even, I don't even know what we'd be reading, like Assault maybe? Like read Assault to get it out. Read Dive to get out, even.
Maybe Red Assault or something. Yeah.
Yeah, and Terror Whispers does get transformed at least, but
He's forced to put a card from discard to Dreamland, so maybe he puts. I can't check the discard right now.
as the first point of damage is done.
Finally.
Yeah. Get those hype emotes in the chat.
Pog
I don't
champ,
even know.
one damage done.
Didn't Gutex get canceled?
I mean, PogChamp is replaced by Komodo Hype.
Wait,
That's the
really?
snake, yeah,
Is that
or
the lore?
lizard. It's not the
Assault
lore,
immediately
it's just what
exceeds.
happened. Okay. But yeah, Gutex did get canceled. Sad. Yeah, this is not looking good at all. So can kind of single player this to a win.
Yeah.
Kalmont just had to really leverage stuff like Hollow Space to make sure that Zolt never hits her. Hollow
Again.
Space and just yeah, Umina's slow. That's the problem for her. She can't avoid. She likes to trade, but yeah. Zolt doesn't really allow for trades, does he?
Oh no. The only cute thing is that she can do like something like an EX Terror Whispers into like a Rage 1 Eye. But other than that, no. There's not much else.
So just like any other character, just defensive EXs.
Yeah.
It's not really.
But at not Rage 1, those defensive EXs don't look good against the eye anyway, so.
You might see a Gunblaze from Zol here actually. Because like I mentioned earlier, Gunblaze Hollow Space doesn't beat Gunblaze.
Beats all space. Nope.
Sweet beats Hollow Space, does it? Yeah, she
Sweep does
that
beat
battle
Hollow
tree trees,
Space.
yeah.
Yeah. Anti-Hollow Space tech.
Yeah, a slow option with extra range beats Hollow Space.
Yeah. Looks like it'd be the only way to
Because of
get cross of
that.
transport from here would be like if he like assaults in or something like that. So I don't know if he's willing to do that, spend four cards from hand. He is
What's his hand
up
again?
in life and can just like prep for 3 turns and be fine, but it dives
Okay,
in.
just wants the positioning. Oh,
The dive doesn't hit.
your dive
Dive
wasn't
doesn't
it.
hit. Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, oh yeah, whoops. Is it nice? Should he allow him to take back like that? I guess he could.
That's fine.
Okay, chooses
And they
not to.
didn't. Yeah, that's fine. There's no funny business here. These guys know each other. That's goofy, though.
Yeah, I mean, because attacks of range one don't hit you. It's not reliant
The
on her being
passive
stuck
stays
on
for
the entire
the
strike.
entirety, yeah.
Yeah.
No matter how many attacks Zolt throws at you.
Pretty
Or how
good.
many times you are stunned or whatever. Move back to range 5. Okay. Interesting.
I think hit the range 5. I don't know. Just seems like a waiting move.
Yeah, no gauge for call. Dark Thoughts can hit. Hollow Space can hit. Don't
Dark
think it's
Thoughts are
coming
down.
out.
That's why I'm saying nothing hits here.
Oh,
It's
yeah,
just a
got
waiting
Nyx
move.
transformed.
There's no
Yeah.
gauge for call Dreamlands, so
No,
it's
no gauge, yep.
I don't know, man. Looks like
One thing is Zul can obviously Zul can just roll in or whatever the moves, whatever the boost on the Ultra is called. Zul can like heighten reflexes.
yeah, move one strike.
Roll. Why did I say roll? Oh, because that's Guile's card.
Yeah, combat roll.
Yep. And there it is.
Second hall space? Actually, no, he can just play Gunblaze and he's fine. There we go. Just play Gunblaze. And you hit him.
I don't think you waste second hall space here. You need that. You need to threaten that as a range one dodge.
No, I'm saying hall space doesn't work anyway because Zul can just
Oh,
play
yeah.
Gunblaze.
You need to keep that hall space though, just so Zolt doesn't stand at range one for free.
Well, at least
Guys, it's in
trade
Gunblaze.
with Gunblaze.
Trade.
The best you can get, kind of, it's the most you can ask for.
Yeah, Zul probably draws two cards here, I think.
Yeah, that makes
Doesn't
sense.
really need two damage right now.
One more cards to fuel
Oh
his
no, he actually takes the two
Ravage.
damage.
Okay.
Cross-up transform. No, fanatical for the advantage. No cross-up. Still left in the seven cards in Zul's deck. That's something. But this is looking, dire.
I said the game was over.
Yeah.
I'm not, I wasn't kidding, by the way.
Yeah,
Like
no, the not actual, not exaggeration in any way.
Umina with no gauge and nothing just looks like a fish out of water. Just like she can't do anything. Against Zul, who just has faster options than her in every way.
And Zul can just prep. He can just sit here and build resources.
Yeah.
What's Umna gonna do?
Umina
I mean, she
just
can
has
boost like
to.
plus five power. She can't even boost plus five power. It's only plus three. Unless she
Plus
replaces
three
the card in
power.
Dreamlands.
Sad.
Yeah, imagine only having plus three power. I mean, she can replace cards in her Dreamlands in mid combat, but still. Right, cross up. Non-drawn. Sad. Oh, wait. No, wait. He didn't parry cross up. What did he parry?
I?
Eyes in there.
Wait, I'm dumb. Focus? I'm just listing off stuff that makes sense.
Well, we can just list out all the cards if you want, but I don't know what was parried.
Could ask.
Hallspace parried in response.
Well, we'll leave it a mystery.
Ah, it's okay. This game's over anyway.
It is. No hall space. No gauge to speak of, except one gauge. 10 life down. Soul full hand.
Yep.
I think Calvantis could just concede and just go for next one. To be honest. I mean, you could try and fight, but feels pretty futile.
Depends on how much mental damage you're taking.
Yeah.
Cross gets replaced by assault.
Okay. That's a good choice. Stunning Mean Assault can steal advantage back.
Stun me assault also Zul can't use assault. Another bonus there.
Yes, that's another thing. Yeah, Assault just really good. Really
What do you
good card to put
have
against in
in at
Dreamlands.
range for dive and gunblaze? And do you have both those in hand?
Let's look at his hand
He
here.
did. 146. No, wait, no, he didn't. He just had Gunblaze, I think.
Probably spent for power here. Gunblaze for
Psycho
power.
miss,
Just hits for
and
six.
then, yep. Get that cross-up transformed, and then get advantage with third one. Unfortunately, he has to, if he want, he actually doesn't even need advantage. Because the only thing he could take advantage with is Eye in his hand, right? Or did he
It's only.
have the Ultra? Do you have a second Fanatical? No, he didn't. So you don't even need to take advantage here, Zolt. You're winning so hard.
Zul can pretty much do anything he wants at this point. Thinking about maybe he doesn't want to transform it. What is he thinking?
He's thinking about if he wants to get advantage. Wait, what? That's what I thought he was doing.
Oh, okay. He wants to wait.
Wait. What? Assaults and Dreamlands. That doesn't work, right? That's not the thing.
Is assault invalid? Am I wrong?
It's in Dreamlands. It's not valid. I don't know. Surely not, right? It's
Oh.
not valid. Yeah, it's not valid.
Can it be actually be played? Oh. Really? You can
What?
execute an attack that's normally invalid? Yeah, my we should check with D here. D!
What?
What the hell is
Is that
this
a thing?
ruling? Can Zolt
Dude.
execute invalid attacks with his
I hate that question. I
leeway?
hate the premise of that question. Can you execute an invalid attack?
Yeah. What the fuck? God, I hate season two. Wait, what?
Oh yeah, dude. That
What? You
is
didn't hear that. You didn't hear that. I love season two. PogChamp.
great.
Janky rulings. Love
Can Zol execute an invalid attack with his UA?
that? I mean, what? By all, by. I don't get it. It
Copies
does.
are invalid for the opponent.
It doesn't make sense, but I mean, wait, oh yeah, Zolt can play Ultras, right? Ultras that are normally invalid, he can play. So if he can,
Yeah, I didn't like that either personally, but
I didn't like that either. Like that didn't make
I
sense
did
to me
not like that at all.
originally.
That didn't make that
It's
did not make sense to me.
completely unintuitive until you learn about it and you're like, oh, that's a thing. Okay.
Dang it, I can't believe our finals controversy is this garbage.
Well, it's Zolt. I mean, what do you expect? Zolt versus Umna, like
I wanted a better controversy.
you got two of the most notorious like rules questions characters on screen right now. Like Umna
Yeah.
Zolt is the source of a bunch of FAQ and rulings because people just don't know how they work. And we see it now. Is D around for
Wow.
this to answer? Hopefully he is.
I mean, at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. Zolt's won this, but
I mean, yeah, it's good to know, but
it's good to know.
Zolt's winning regardless, even if he doesn't
Yeah.
get to play this assault, but it's good to
That
Let's
is. Is there an Umina FAQ?
I don't know if there's Umina FAQ pertaining Zolt's execute follow-up attacks.
Should we get Brad on the line?
Brad, oh, the president of level 99. I don't think
President of Level 99 Games, Brad,
man,
something.
I don't even think he knows. It's mostly just ask D.
Yeah.
That's why we're asking D because D's the expert.
Yeah. Yeah.
Jeez.
I hope this doesn't take too long, otherwise I'm gonna have to cut it. Nah, I probably won't cut it.
That was funny.
It's goofy. It's not funny, it's goofy.
It's funny that Zolt can do something as messed up as play invalid attacks.
Yeah.
But he could play Ultras that are normally invalid, so I wouldn't be surprised if Zolt could.
Oh, I wouldn't be surprised if this goes either way, honestly. Oh, he's typing.
Let's see it. Let's see it. Don't tell me it's a question that D doesn't know the answer
Let's
to.
get Jungi on the line and see what he has to say.
Yeah, can TO
Make a ruling
intervention.
for the next tournament for this one very specific instance.
Yeah. Zolt was a mistake.
You know what? If D doesn't know, I'm going to make the ruling as the host of the room. Amazing. It
Yeah.
completely ignores validation. It's valid.
Incredible.
Amazing.
Yep, so he gets off his advantage.
Yeah, with his invalid attack, which is actually totally valid.
Is executing CPAT. He's executing an assault. It's not.
Invalid is like the strongest word you can use for that, for what it means. It doesn't even work. Like, what's a word stronger than invalid?
Destroy a card. I don't know.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Game over, man. Game over.
Put Umna at range 2, cross up to range 3.
Actually.
No, puts him at range 1. Puts her at range 1, excuse me.
Oh, he had another assault. I forgot. Wait.
Now
He did? He had two assaults? Oh, maybe he just
we
recently did
have 2 invalid attacks here.
Let's
And yeah, this
go. Let's
and that is
go.
four
Hype.
as a
Hype.
4 damage I. Back-to-back invalid attacks finish the game for Zolt. Season
Oh
2,
my
baby.
God. Zolt finished the game by taking 4 turns in a row. Two of
Taking
them
4 turns
off
in
of
a row,
invalid attacks.
two of them within two off the back of 2 invalid
Sick.
attacks.
I love this character, man. Zolt's so cool. He's so badass when he does his combos.
That's so cool. Calvance now gets his matchup, maybe. Unless Mix goes for the Plague Knight. Mix goes for the Plague Knight, yes!
CPAT's happy.
Yes!
CPAT's happy.
Plague Knight's so cool. Plague Knight's, for those of you that don't know, Plague Knight's my favorite character. Plague Knight is on my tournament team for the tournaments I'm never gonna play. Plague Knight is the best. He's so cool. You can add it, you can add before hit and after triggers to your attacks to make him super cool. You can do 17 damage triple doses if you like your one shots. You can refill your hand. I love it. Yeah, you got a speed 6 ignore guard that also gives you card draw. I love that card.
Yeah, fair and balanced
Perfect
character.
pitch. Beautiful. Lots of movement.
Plague Knight is. I always like to say Plague Knight is just like Zolt with extra steps because he can craft like really disgusting
Yes, you
strikes.
can craft really.
Just like
It's like
unbeatable
it's,
stuff.
yeah, I love it. This character's so cool.
But you know,
Plague Knight,
he requires
game
more effort to
3.
do so. Nice. He didn't
I
want to
have
play the
no idea how it
Hakumen
fares
in that
into Umna,
matchup.
but
That's
yeah.
smart of him.
He knew. He knew.
What is this? Is this a Calvatus fan club in chat right now?
That's the only reason you're streaming, right? Is because he wanted all of his friends.
Yeah, everybody, a lot of people watching that.
Sorry, guys. We are Team Plague Knight here.
I'm not Team Plague
Season
Knight, but
two. Get season. Your team season 2. Over Plague Knight, the coolest season 4 character of the coolest season. Season 4.
Plague Knight play kind of disgusts me, but it's fine. Frantic
That's because you
Research.
forget about triple. That because you also forgot about triple dose. That's why.
Was when I was a scrub.
Yeah.
Yes, Frantic Research to boost assist, draw four
Frantic
cards.
Research, beautiful boost. Draw 2 cards that strike after draw 2 cards into an EX attack. Classic Plague Knight move. I'm so hyped for this.
The boost just says draw four cards, let's be real.
Yeah.
Because no, why would you make that, or why would you play anything that doesn't that gets you stunned with this? You won't.
Because Yomi. I don't know. Because Yomi. The sweep. EX Giant Bomb! Oh, it
He'll
doesn't blow up
trade.
the
He'll
sweep.
trade.
Yeah, it'll trade. But.
Each eyeball's pretty safe.
Yeah, I guess the hull space doesn't matter because it's an after. Pulls a dive. EX Giant Bomb, let's go. Yeah, pretty good trade, actually.
Oh, you're happy with as Umina.
Plague Knight gets a billion cards out of it. Assault goes in the Dreamlands. Okay, it's beautiful, beautiful character right here. I love Plague Knight. This is it. This is game. Reminder to everyone watching: this is a best of three set. This is not best of five like the last final. So this is it.
Yeah,
This
this
is
for all the rebels.
whoever wins this game takes the set and the match and the tournament and the prize money. What's the prize money? Is it like $20 or something?
20 or 25 bucks, something like that.
Yeah.
So, range two.
Cross beats the focus.
Nice.
Mixed bits of card, but cross beats the focus. Range four. Range four, not fantastic for Plague Knight. Really wants to get a little bit closer than that.
I like that cross a lot. It was very brave to do. Just in the
Think
face,
what?
of perfect pitch.
Yes, yeah.
You have to do it.
Okay, we'll take a look at his
It's
powerhouse of the
just
card again.
mix-ups. It's just mix-ups at the
Yeah,
end of the
it's
day.
just mix-ups, exactly. Beautiful card.
So he's
Berserker's
setting
Brew
up.
coming out.
Interesting.
Pulls the
After draw
chain
four.
reaction after draw, yep.
I wonder what's this other card then. Second chain reaction? Could be.
Yeah. Hopefully
Could be
it's not
a
like a
second
hope.
copy, just as guaranteed.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, I mean, hopefully it's not mixed going for like a 50-50 and you whiff like a dive or something. That'd be really bad.
Yeah, just block it. Good call.
And is the long pitch.
Force engage.
Mixed spending.
He may spend. Does he want to spend Air Force? Maybe not. No, he doesn't.
No, doesn't.
So just
I guess
seek
he really
power.
likes that other card. Whatever it is, he really likes it.
I'm guessing it's just another chain reaction. Just
Yeah,
saving it for
maybe.
later.
Maybe. That's a five power long pitch coming in.
Six power.
Assuming Umna six power. Did he spend any? Did he spend one force before?
Berserker's Brew.
Oh, he full spent that?
He full
I don't
spent.
remember.
He spent an
Okay.
ultra for it.
Okay. I thought he Okay, never mind. Yeah. Okay, cool. Mixed prepping. And Umna discards one copy of Call of the Dreamlands to take nothing.
Come on, Calvontis, you gotta win this and buy dinner for your friends.
Are you have you been swayed by your Twitch chat?
They're making me Calvontis fans now, what can I say?
Okay.
I've always been a
Does
fan.
this mean I can now be outwardly Plague Knight
We
biased?
already got a
As
caster.
of
We already got a caster
no.
that loves Plague Knight, so he's cheering for Mix 100%.
Yeah, but that was me inwardly trying to hide my bias for Plague Knight. So yeah. Man, Plague Knight's so cool. It's interesting that he mixed spent from hand. And playing instead of like spending. So what I like to do is Plague Knight is I like to exceed early personally to set up the disgusting strikes, but Mix opting not to do that instead spends from gauge for to validate the long pitch. Maybe Mix doesn't like exceeding as much as I do. I don't know. I've never seen Mix's Plague Knight before. And there are a lot of lines. Plague Knight is like I say a lot about Hasuma. Plague Knight's another character like this. You can do no wrong with the character, you know? There are a lot of lines that you can take that give you a high chance to win.
Yeah, I mean, first I play Knight works perfectly fine. Back then I play Knight just like you can
That's
I.
super disgusting, but not necessary.
Yeah, exactly. Sometimes you just need one thing tacked on. But yeah, I mean, play Knight is a fairly card hungry character, so it
Yeah,
makes sense to
but
just like spend gauge aggressively.
On the other hand, he has a billion ways to draw cards.
Yes.
Like that draws on both the boost and the attack. This does not draw. That's the only one that doesn't draw. This one draws technically, although it spends a force and then has the after on it as well. Boosting Spike in response to the plus two power.
Set a pretty good call to Dreamlands here.
Yeah, but Call of Dreamlands on
Goes for reading, makes sense.
Yeah, it goes for reading into it. Call of Dreams without the reading would be like a little bit risky. Mixed did spend only one focus, but like your hand gets revealed. Focus whiffs. Reading whiffs. We see a hand of chain reaction,
Oof.
assault, castle crasher, perfect pitch, block, grasp. I mean, to be fair, not a whole lot you can do against a Call of the Dreamlands if it is Call of the Dreamlands.
No, it's probably Dark Tides.
Yes.
No, he's happy with this. Any
Yeah.
block, he doesn't matter, doesn't care. Mix didn't have
Yeah,
to
Call of
cross, which
Dreamlands
is what.
is a little bit of a sketchy card
Mix
when
didn't have
it's
to
not
cross or
finishing a game.
dive, so it's fine. Okay. Place this assault with an assault.
Assault is like a cute way to get in as Plague Knight. Discard the assault. Now your attack is before close to. It's
And gain
pretty good.
advantage.
It's not a bad card to steal. Yeah, and you get advantage as well, but.
I'm pretty sure Assault's the only normal has two effects. Yes, it does. So Assault's actually really good for any kind of
Is it?
like for
Yeah, you're
Yakuza
right.
as well. Like any kind of character that adds before it hit after effects,
Nah,
Assault's really
Yakuza
good
doesn't
attack
even
on
have a
damage.
backside, dude.
Yakuza's backside's really good though. His front side's just fun.
It's fun side's fun. That's what matters.
I think Umina definitely has the upper hand here. Umina has a
I'm
lot
just
of
winning,
resources
you
now.
know. Yeah, ton of resources. Okay, here comes the exceed action.
Yeah.
Take a look at backside Plague Knight. You can do the same thing twice now. So you can discard two cards randomly from your hand to add all before hit and after triggers on the discarded card to your attack. And you can actually
Yes.
do it one at a time as well, so you don't have to say I'm doing it twice. So like if you hit your target, then you don't have to do it again.
Yeah. But ideally, as Plague Knight, you just leave two cards in hand and you want them both to execute. You can 100% do that very easily with boosts like Serum Supernus.
Castle Crasher, yep. Take a look at this bad boy of a boost here. Plus two power, plus two speed, plus two armor, now strike.
Might as well
Cost a
say you
billion,
win.
doesn't matter. Cost a billion, doesn't matter.
Yes, it doesn't matter since you have after draw four.
Bomb
Nice
burst.
situation one.
Plague Knight has a lot of movement. He does need to get in close. The only ranged option he has is the Ultra Castle Crasher and Long Pitch, which doesn't do a whole lot. Okay, Umna setting up for a big strike here with the plus two speed and a plus four power.
Not bad. Yeah, Plague Knight has to
Not
go
bad at
for
all. Yeah, agree. Not bad at all.
it. And he has a Stunning Moon Assault. Pretty much, Umna only has to worry about Plague Knight crossing out. That's it.
Yeah, but she still has both copies of Terra Whispers left as well.
Yeah, this actually is really not good. All these stats and Plague Knight just spent a
They're too big.
yeah.
They're too big for Plague Knight's guard.
It's only like Plague Knight's just like, oh my god, I want out now. I came in, now I want to leave. Yeah, techs are extremely important against Umna because you really want to tech Dreamtelling. I've learned that the hard way that you really need to save dice against Umna
Powerhouse of
because
a
Dreamtelling
boost.
is
Yeah.
so messed up.
Powerhouse of a boost.
It's like I think Giant Killer, like Beheaded's boost plus four power for 1/4. I think Giant Killer's messed up. And Dreamtelling is just Giant Killer, but even more messed up.
Yeah. It's that plus an after adds a gauge as well.
Yeah. Pretty good.
Not bad at all. Not bad at all. Yeah, Plague Knight staring down like an 8 to 11 damage something. Ups a prep. Discards down the spike.
Is he maybe digging for
Block.
block or Serum Supernus?
Serum Supernus in theory, but Umna has EX Terra Whispers.
Right, I'm gonna decide to strike, cashing out.
EX Grasp. Beats the. Oh, it doesn't beat because it's stun immune.
Hits back
So
for
hits
seven.
back for eight. Yeah, it's eight
Seven
minus
after
one armor.
armor.
Yes, seven.
Gains advantage, stun immune.
Stun immune. Yeah, the season four normals, hard to see them from, at least for me. It's hard to see them, from afar.
Good combat win, but Plague Knight still. I mean, Plague Knight being able to
Like that was able
trade
to respond and
is a
dealt
miracle.
like four damage. That's fine.
Yeah. It's not a bad response considering the stats he was up against.
Totally okay. Second unknown Kadath coming out as the boost.
Yep. Oh boy. I think this could be, this is setting up
This
for
is the
EX,
scary one.
probably setting up for
EX
EX Terra
Shadow
Whispers.
Terra Whispers, yeah.
Yeah.
I always get the names mixed up.
Shadow
They're all
Chorus, Terra.
like vaguely negative Cthulhu-esque things.
Yeah, I mean, Kadath is, and Dreamlands are literally just straight from Lovecraft. You would think I would really like Umina. Just because she's a walking Lovecraft reference, but I don't know.
Not a fan.
I find her annoying to fight against. Not too much of a fan.
Play as her then.
Just play as her, yeah.
Yeah, just play as her. This is a simple solution to your problem right there.
Definitely an interesting control character, but
He's super interesting.
just a lot of weird rule stuff that I don't like.
Yeah.
Such a season two, though. I don't know how the mix is going to respond to this, to be honest. Maybe just, I
The
don't
one
know.
response I can think of that is really good is you Serum Supernus into the Ignore Guard.
No guard, yeah. Actually,
Four
that seems all
power, eight
right.
speed.
May,
That's
may.
all right.
No, but then she can play just play Stun Immune Assault and just be like, okay,
Oh,
you play the
yeah.
fast
Oh,
ignore
yeah, because
guard
she
thing.
can. Yeah, I always forget she can just, like, physically, like, rip the card out of the Dreamlands and just play that. I
Yeah.
always forget that.
She doesn't have to play Shadow Chorus or and
Yeah.
she could just play it.
And there's still a mix up there then, right? Because you can always cross. It's cross frantic guard or frantic research. What's the card name? Staff of Surging. Frantic research the boost. Staff of Surging cross mix up is a thing. It is really expensive, though.
Really expensive, yeah.
It's really expensive, and Mix, judging by his play, does not like to go on low hand sizes Plague Knight.
You need the force for Serum Supernus.
He's a billion force in here. He's like two ultras left. Boots bait bomb. A little bit of a stall-y play.
Interesting. I don't
Basically,
see
like
it
a
used that much.
I boost a lot early. To get the gauge.
Just like a fancy key charge, yeah.
Yeah. And like with a prepare action on it, except you spend a force. So yeah, it's basically a fancy key charge
It's hidden
with a little bit of
weapons.
extra deck cycling.
Actually, it's just hidden weapons, but with more options, with more curation.
Yes. Yeah. So you look at the top three. Yep. Late, I sometimes use it to get the third gauge to threaten triple dose, but.
Oh, triple
Seems like a
dose.
little bit of a stally play, like a little bit too stally for me. Blocks the Shadow Chorus. Okay.
So this
I
is
guess he was
just
searched to. It's a way to search for block and also get gauge.
that makes
Also
sense. Stick to his deck.
cycles a normal out as well.
Yeah, Plague Knight only has one card
Because
left in deck, so yeah.
reading is a thing. This is going to be eight damage assault coming in. Really mixes the cards like a triple dose or something, Castle Crasher, and one other card.
Want to get as much damage as possible.
Opts to not spend from gauge, so now that triple dose is live.
Umino with advantage. Umino really should really look to get Terra Whisper soon, so that she has so much gauge to spend it with the
Yes, to
transform.
get.
Just
Well, to
force
go
an
get
opponent
that
wall swing and
transform right now.
just die.
So, as an action, you may spend two gauge. If you do strike, the opponent must defend with a wild swing. Look at that card art. That's something else. Yeah, Umna has a billion gauge right now. Name's Triple Dose, okay. Triple Dose is the last card
Really?
in Mix's deck, yep.
Really? Wow.
Staff Surging, Perfect Pitch, Focus Assault. Wow.
Huh.
Triple Dose is also, if that gets stolen, that's a way for Calvantis to close out the game with his gauge. Yeah, a little bit unlucky there for Calvantis. That last card is Triple Dose.
He didn't really need the hand info, so that's just unlucky that he didn't snipe it.
Yeah.
But okay, Umna's still sitting pretty comfortably on advantage.
Well, not only snipe it, but also like deny Plague Knight from using it now, right? Like using it this turn.
Yeah.
Especially with, something like Perfect Pitch, draw three cards, make your opponent discard three cards. Not
Perfect
bad at all.
pitch. Oh yeah, you can just that resolves three times, yeah. Godlike. Just destroy your opponent's
Yep.
hand and make yours full.
Exactly. You're not so sad discarding Focus either. Just draw three cards. It's two hits right there.
That all just kind of messed up.
It's all right. It's not bad. Reading.
Interesting.
And he's probably going to boost. I'm assuming this is going to be like a reading. I don't know if
Five
he's going for
picture.
Staff of Surging or if he's going for an assault. He's going for an assault. Misses. You saw him with Terra Whispers?
You just play Tire Whispers here, yeah.
Yeah. Beats everything. It beats everything.
Yes.
A little bit of a home run play.
That was very Hail Mary, yeah.
Well, it's very Hail Mary if he has one spike left. It's like not so Hail Mary if he has two.
Would say Hail Mary just because
Wait,
flip.
what? He didn't have perfect. He didn't have it.
Wait, he didn't have
He
Spike?
didn't have it. No, I'm saying Mix didn't have Triple Dose. His last card was Dive.
Oh, so he just wants hand info?
No, he just made a mistake.
Oh.
Surely he doesn't want hand info. He's trying to steal the Triple Dose.
Yeah. I guess it's just a mistake then. I don't expect
Yeah.
Calvantis to make mistakes ever. That's why I was confused.
I don't remember where the second Triple Dose dropped. I remember one dropping because it boosts, he boosted it. Did he drop the second one
No,
on
he spent the
unlock or
other for
something?
force. He spent the other one for force. That's what happened. He
I see.
played, pretty sure he did.
Did he boost it and spend the other one as
He
force
played
for that?
Berserker's Brew and then he spent triple
He
dose
spent it
again
for
for
that.
two force. I
Yeah.
think that's what happened.
Okay.
So,
What does I'm gonna take back here to put in Dreamlands?
can't see her discard, but I would assume maybe some sort of normal. Normals are usually some of the best things to put in Dreamlands just
If there's a
because.
shadow course left, maybe put focus back.
I mean, that's a good normal.
It's good normal. I don't think you put focus back if there isn't a shadow course left, though. Unless you're like planning on exceeding, in which case you can take cards from your Dreamlands back. Right, so this could also be like soft recursion for Umna, right? Because when Umna exceeds, she puts cards into her Dreamland every turn, and then the card from the Dreamland comes to hand. So this could be soft recursion as well.
Right. That could be what you're setting up for. We definitely could see Exceed Umina here just to close out the game. See, Umna is extremely good at closing out games.
Yep. No threat of
Card
deck
mill.
out either. Yep. No season two here, so no threat of deck out.
There's only one character that can mill you out. And that's we don't talk about him.
Pretty sure one of Calvance's games yesterday, he almost got milled out as Umna.
Well, milling
Against
himself
Volt.
out, is it?
He milled himself out, yeah.
Oh yeah, I mean, yeah.
He got close. I mean, he lost before, I think. Or he won. I don't know. I remember if he lost or he won. There was a result, and I think Umna had like three cards left in her deck. Or like
Oh.
two, even. Maybe even one. I don't quite remember. I was playing on my Switch, but okay, takes the holospace back. Good combat card.
Pretty good. There we go.
Yep, and there's the exceed.
Nice. So she gets so we're looking at her seed side Dreamlands, where she says stack she can add the Dreamlands card to gain all before hit after it triggers. So for in Holospace's case, she can seal it to gain advance or retreat tree after.
We'll take a look at this. And Dreamlands gets a new ability as well. Also, that exceed was free, so we have six gauge here for Silver Key. I mean, playing that Swan Swings can still, in theory, be scary if he attaches random stuff to it. You know?
Yeah, he could. He definitely could, even for a wall swing.
Yeah. Like a lot of Plague Knight stuff hits at this kind of range. Like the only, depending on whether you're at range one or range two, either the Staff of Surging or the Perfect Pitch won't hit. Like everything else hits, right?
That's the recursion you were talking about. Holospace returning a hand. Forces Plague Knight to wall swing and plays EX out of mind.
Spike will not work. That gets stunned.
Stunned. Five power out of mind.
Pretty good.
Yeah, Plague Knight
Five powers
just
of
moved to
speed.
range two here just to hope that, he'll get a good Plague Knight. I mean, this is range two is Umna's weakest range, and Plague Knight's good at range two. So you just standing there. He still has the perfect pitch in hand.
Yeah, so like the perfect pitch was even less likely to be Wild Swan, right? Because he has one in hand.
Yeah.
That was the only out
It's the only out against EX out
against
of mind, yeah.
EX out of mind. Yep. On curve. At range two. This is gonna be a Staff of Surging boost as Frantic Research.
Oh, giant
Giant
bomb.
Bomb.
We'll dodge.
Yep, we'll
Okay.
dodge the focus.
Played focus to play around perfect pitch.
Perfect pitch, yep. A little bit of a mix up there.
Good play from Mix.
Shadow Chorus, of course, cannot go to the Dreamlands.
That was a dead one, but that's fine.
Yep. That's the one dead card in five cards for Umina.
Okay, Mix taking note of what cards were known.
Umina moves to range one.
Smart. Double holospace in hand. Range one
Not bad.
is where she thrives.
Yeah, Link's gotta find his way to range two or range three.
That's a good, just a good waiting move to wait for something to actually end up in Dreamlands.
But of course, Plague does have ways to both in and out of combat to move. He has tons of boosts, and of course, he can just add a movement effect like on a before to his attack. Plague Knight, baby. Although Plague Knight not looking so hot right now in terms of health. Striking one card, no discard, forcing the holospace.
Oh,
Okay, interesting.
interesting.
Calvance opts to not holospace there. Celeste two in hand. That's the thing. Like you have it as a threat. You don't have to play it.
Exactly.
You don't have to play it. In fact, the threat a lot of times in Exceed, especially in Exceed where you only have two copies of a card, the threat is more important than actually playing it at times.
I have played around cards that just never showed up for the opponent all game.
Yeah. Of course, the Staff of Surging doesn't really do anything because it's only Ignore Guard, and that block is not getting stunned. So no card draw on that. A little bit sad for Plague Knight. She's super sad for Plague Knight. Super sad because both of those are now downed, I believe.
What are both down?
Staff of Surging.
Oh, I see. Yeah, both are
Little
down.
sad. A little sad. Hand revealed here. See a hand of EX Holospace, which we knew about. One copy of the Terra Whispers. Call of the Dreamlands, a Spike, and a Dark Thoughts.
There's a spike. Quick, do a reading.
Quick.
Do a reading before it's gone.
No, just read into. Dude, imagine if his last four cards were triple dose, EX Castle Crasher reading. He's dead. Like, Umra's actually dead there, right? Because that triple dose is a 17.
That would be hilarious if it actually happened. And unlucky
Yeah.
for Calwandis if that were to happen.
Very, very sad. And that, of course, is the transform slipping away. When you place a card in your Dreamlands, you can spend a force if you do draw one. Kalvantis smartly gets rid of the other normal in his hand by boosting it for power.
Oh, that's something. I almost forgot his transformation exists. Nice way to use it, though.
It's good. It's a good one.
Slipping away is really good for, yeah, especially CD Umna. Just gives her like star turn movement.
Yeah, can also now like escape things because now he has more space on the side of the board. Where Plague Knight's range is only like up to here.
Get the
Umna can slip up to
Holospace in the
back
dream
here.
tree.
Yep.
Sadly, Plague Knight is not broken enough to have Gunblaze and catch Holospace.
No,
Too bad.
not quite. They learned. They learned after season two.
They print Gunblaze and they're like, wait, what?
Yeah.
Why do we print this card like this?
Yeah, man, if Perfect Pitch was in season two, it'd be a 1-3.
It would.
Yeah,
If it was season two, yeah, it would just be an eye.
it'd just be an eye instead of just Rage 2. Big advantage here for Plague Knight.
You mean
Or
Umna?
sorry, for Umina, yeah. Not Umina, the
Oh
Dreamer Awakened.
yeah, sorry, new character.
New character.
Just like
Dreamer
how, yeah,
Awakened.
Zolt becomes Hunter and then.
Never actually seen this art, or zoomed in on this art before. That is,
You haven't? It's pretty sick.
that's spooky. That's spooky. Yeah, 'cause my brain's not big enough to function back. I can barely run front side Umina. Why would I ever exceed? Brain's not big enough for that. So,
Too much brain power.
yeah.
Whose turn is it?
Plague Knight's turn.
Oh,
Umna
okay.
has Umna, dude. Umna has like EX Holospace with a dive attached to it. That's pretty good.
Oh yeah, that's messed up. That's
Yeah, it is. It still
actually
is.
incredibly
Messing
messed
it.
up.
Yeah, when you set an attack, if you see the card in this area to add all of your before hit or after, it's like Plague Knight. I guess Umna is, or I guess Plague Knight is like Umna because Umna came first. But yeah, so this before effect can be attached to Holospace, EX Holospace
She
even.
can actually hit with Holospace right now.
Yes, she can hit with Holospace
And
for
dodge literally
eight,
everything.
seven damage, and also dodge everything. Yep.
Jesus, what do you even do?
The only thing you can do is Plague Knight has like Plague Knight can attach something to his combat with it before to be faster, and end up at like range two or something. But the only thing is he can only really attach dive,
You guys
as
are
far as
tiny.
like movement is concerned. As far as before combat movement is concerned, he can only attach dive. So it would have to be like exactly dive and like EX assault or something, you know? There are very few ways to surely that. Oh, okay. Takes the dive and puts Spike in there now.
Interesting. Maybe
Interesting indeed.
he just wants dive as force?
No, it's just that the EX Holospace that hits is too unfair.
Oh,
It's
yeah.
too unfair.
He said to go easy on him, put the dive
Yeah.
away. Yeah, 'cause her UA is optional, so
Yes.
You don't have to replace it, but Galvan just chooses to anyway. Even though Spike will not provide any benefits. So clearly he just wants the extra card for something.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what. I don't know. I don't see it. I don't see it. Well, I'm not an Umna player, so I don't see it.
Yeah.
I tried playing Umna right before I quit this game.
Wonder you
Was the
quit.
last character. Yeah, that was the last character I was working on. I only got one game in. I got two games in. I lost to a 1-14 EX Ground Zero off a Wild Swing.
Nice.
Yeah. That was the nail in the coffin for me. Was it
You
1-14? 1-13, maybe.
should play this
Where
game
like
more. I like seeing you salty.
I played 2 days ago.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying you should play more. I just like seeing you salty.
Yeah, thank you.
It
It's good content.
is. Just
It's good
molding over
content.
wall swings. I love
Dude,
it.
if I ever do Pookie versus the world. I actually made a thumbnail for it already, but I don't know if I'm gonna do it.
Some big commitments to
Dude,
lose
Calvontis was like, "Are you
56
really sure
times.
you want to commit to Pookie?" I was like, "No, I have no idea." Depends on how entertaining it is to watch me lose all the time.
Pookie versus world, more like lose versus the world.
Yeah, more like the world crushes little bunny.
Yeah.
It's over and over again. Especially because any like setups I had with Pookie are long gone because I haven't played that character in months. Like any like little tricks I had, I don't remember a single one.
Should ask extra for Pookie tips.
Should.
Great Pookie player, by the way.
Yeah, we saw him win on your channel, actually.
Yep. Gambling.
Umna are
So,
really taking your time here.
yeah, this is
On this
Calvontis'
turn.
turn, yeah.
Yep. This is Calvontis trying to figure out a way to win here. This is MO. When he's taking time like this in the end game, he's trying to find a way to win here. I don't really see it at 9 life though. So it's gotta be like a 2 turn plan.
Kawada is just like, how many unbeatable attacks can I throw at him?
Yeah.
Kawada does love his unbeatable
That's an
attacks.
EX he's gearing up for.
Perhaps.
I mean, look, did you see the way he moved his mouse like 45 degrees northeast? That was him like trying. That was him like deciding whether to like select those two cards to play an EX.
Right.
Dude, if this game would be so easy if it was just like tells with the mouse. Unfortunately, I'm bad at the rest of Xyz, so it's not the
Yeah,
most useful thing, but there you go.
this is the next level play. It's just
There
watch you find this
it is. He
mouse.
shuffled ahead. Guaranteed EX. Guaranteed.
Going for
Silver
Silver
key.
Key. Yep. Oh. There we go.
Silver key, one card. Force the wild swing. Mix actually has a decision whether he wants to add before hits and afters to this attack,
There's no
which
decision.
is a non-trivial decision.
There's no decision because Spike is in Dreamlands.
No, I'm not saying for Umna, I'm saying for
Oh,
Plague Knight.
for Plague Knight. Ah, yes. You can.
Yeah, that's a non-trivial decision. I think Mix has had
He may go
a
for it.
full. Yeah, he's going for it. Pulls the dive.
Four advanced three, okay. Oh
That
well.
doesn't do anything. I mean,
Just
that was
plays the grasp. Excuse me, Tire Whispers. But you just grasp.
yeah. Little baby grasp. Cool art
Oh,
though.
place unknown Kadaf into Dreamlands. That actually has a really cool before effect that can just
Yeah.
add a strike instantly. That's actually really
Yeah.
bad for Treasure Knight.
Like literally you can the only thing is
I mean, Plague Knight.
Plague Knight. The only thing is he's down both Terra Whispers and down to grasp. So like unless he has a second grasp, that's where it's really bad, right? Because that's a reach, that's a speed 7 and the
And a
strike.
strike, yeah.
Yeah. Speed 6 is like it's fine. Defense is a little sketchy. We'll take a look at this card real quick.
Thanks for the follow, SK Muffin. I don't stream much, but hey, maybe I'll stream Exceed more or something.
Stream the what should we call it? The casuals that new person's running. What's their name again?
Chimera, MTG.
Chimera. Stream Chimera casuals.
That'll
That's a
be
good name.
it's a chill. That'll be pretty chill.
It's a good name. Yeah. Unknown Kadath
Might as well
gets
get in hand.
replaced. Yeah, get in hand for free.
Mixtape of
I
Moons.
don't know how Plague Knight wins this.
It's
Plague
like a
Knight needs like three combats to win, and three good combats to win, or like five bad ones.
Yeah,
I
because he's
guess
never
four bad
landing triple
ones.
dose ever.
Yeah.
It's tough, really tough.
Yeah, Plague Knight doesn't have any sort of advantage shading besides assault, so this is tricky. Range four, not the best range either.
And obviously with six cards in hand, it's on defense. It's going to be a
Six
purely
cards in
down to
hand. Hasn't
luck, pretty much. What?
even drawn a focus to read the no normals in Umina's hand, which are a spike and dive, I believe.
Oh yeah.
Right.
Oh
That
shit.
is a Dreamlands move back one into call, probably.
Yeah. Maybe.
Unfortunately, can't play call and also force a Wild Swing. So there's something.
He can't call Dreamless is 2 gauge. Actually, oh yeah, it takes 4 gauge total, right?
Yes, it takes 4 gauge total to force the Wild Swing afterward. Still totally fine. Kalvat is looking at the discard, probably counting how many focuses are left. But the thing is, like, Mix would have played reading at some point, right? I guess
Yeah.
if there's two left, there's a decent chance that he's wrong. By decent, I mean like 25% or something. Yeah, there's the strike, probably called the Dreamlands.
It's Caller Dark Tots.
Dark Thoughts also works because you can't really.
Just had to cross out.
Yeah.
Get across. Oh, okay, that was just the Dark Tots. Didn't want to
Was the Dark
commit the
Thoughts, yeah.
gauge. Yeah.
Yeah, the only way Dark Thoughts doesn't work is if you get like a double move forward, double lurch forward or something like that, you know?
Yeah,
With the
if Plague
Plague
Knight
Knight.
stacks like before
Yeah.
advance and another before advance.
Yeah, exactly. Which, like, he doesn't have a ton of, just assault and dive.
Just normals.
Yeah. Play guy we super super play guy we too good if he had one on his specials, I think.
Yeah. Good thing Plague Knight doesn't have much movements on his before and afters.
Yeah,
His only movement on his after is on
he has
Giant
a, he has
Bomb.
af he has after movement. He doesn't have a ton of before, right? Because he has giant bomb and he has no. I guess he just
It's
has
just
giant
Giant
bomb.
Bomb. It's just Giant Bomb.
Yeah. Plague Knight now finds himself at range 7. Not ideal.
No, not really.
Not ideal. But has to, like, if he moves in, has to move in a lot, otherwise he's getting bopped by a call or something.
Yeah, like he's forced to cross to not get hit, but then it's like, oh, I have to move back in
Now I'm
eventually
here.
to
Yeah.
try and hit him.
Has a bunch of resources, though. Has 4 gauge. Although, you really do want to be threat. Even if it's not going to hit, you really do want to be threatening those ultras, I think. Down this much life, you want to at least threaten them, even if you're not going to use them.
Trent Castle Crasher at least.
Yeah. You can triple this. Just threaten it. Threaten it, maybe force the Unknown Kadath to come out, something like that. I know that there are a billion ways to dodge triple dose or Castle Crusher.
Yeah, Plague Knight has to navigate a minefield in addition to making a massive
Castle
comeback.
Crusher actually looks. Oh, no, it doesn't. It's only speed 3. I
It's only speed
forgot.
three. Oh.
Yeah. Speed 3 armored. It's got a ton of armor on it, anyways. Plague Knight moves to range 6, so this is threatening something like a dive into triple dose, I guess. Or dive into any. I just said triple dose because that's like the obvious high payout one, but
Right.
dive into something that hits at range 3. And even then, I'm pretty sure if there's only one dive in here, it's only a 50-50 that the dive actually gets pulled. That's the thing about Plague Knight, is that when you play high hand Plague Knight like that, you don't guarantee your strikes. So there's like a little bit of a risk there. It's like there's a little bit of risk on whether you want to have a low hand and then not have as many resources in hand, or you want a high hand and not guarantee that you get the pull that you want.
Well, that's mostly applicable, only applicable on defense, though. And on defense, generally, you want more cards, has more answers, so.
Yeah, but in the scenario you're looking at Hail Marys, I think. You're looking at one Hail Mary.
One Hail Mary pull.
One Hail Mary. Yeah, that's what you need. Notably, Hollow Space hits. EX Hollow Space. Does he still have EX Hollow Space?
He's had it. He's still having it. Yeah.
So EX Hollow Space is speed 5 on initiation. Do you just do it and then force the Wild Swing? I guess EX
Yeah.
Hollow Space is like expensive, right? It's if it whiffs, it sucks. But if you force the Wild Swing, let's say there's only one dive in, like even if it's a dive situation, it's fine because Hollow Space is speed 5, so you would need a speed 6 for you need a speed 6 or a speed 7 Wild Swing, but nothing that Plague Knight has at range 3 is speed 6 or speed 7.
Yeah, range 6 hull space is just free, more or less.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, he's gonna seal this for close to. Nice. Close to.
Just playing Plague Knight.
Yeah, he's playing that now.
Except it's guaranteed, so it's better.
I don't know if Plague
Close
Knight's down
to an
crosses.
EX, Castle Crash for armor. Also trades with Call of the Dreamlands.
Yeah. Will he?
What? We are taking that back. And now we are playing it again. Hollow Space. So Hollow Space
Okay.
will only do 0 damage.
Zero damage. Game
And
advantage.
Castle Crusher will hit back for 8.
He's back for 8, yeah. Ooh. Oh.
No, it
Oh,
dodges
yeah,
because
after. Oh.
it's a I for I
Yeah,
it's a close
close
two,
to,
so
and
it
then
dodges.
after advanced.
Yeah. That was almost sick. I mean, he lived, so.
Well, he was hoping that it was not call space and that it was call, probably.
Super big brain to not silver key there, forcing Mix to spend the gauge. Huge brain. Galaxy brain.
Just enforcing the threat of Call of Dreamlands made him play Castle Crasher to try and trade with it, and as a result, he gets smoked. Rip.
Drops the 3 gauge. Can't even triple dose now. Not that was ever gonna hit, but can't do it.
This is looking
Can't
like
do
game
it.
over.
I mean, it's been looking like game over for a while, but yeah.
It has. It feels like a long, drawn out, painful death.
And that, of course, is that boost again. Sorry, the transform. Yep, and that's probably game. Oh no, it's only 4 damage.
Yeah, 4 damage. Oh, gains advantage.
Didn't even need to silver key there.
Yeah, he didn't.
Mix just had to Wild Swing because he didn't have anything.
No
Went for the
answers.
Hail Mary on the poles as well.
Playing that range tree kind of sucks, actually. Not that good.
It's like Giant Bomb and Chain Reaction. There's a second triple dose. And that is the game. Calavosis takes it. Plague Knight loses. Sad.
You hate to see poor Plague Knight lose. Oh, he had a dive.
He
He
had
had an
dive in
answer.
hand. He had an answer.
But he didn't.
But
He
it,
didn't.
yeah, but
I
and
mean,
then
it's only
it,
the,
but
like,
the only
sort
thing
of
is,
delaying the inevitable,
yeah,
though.
it's like a then and then what situation, right?
Yeah, exactly. He's like, okay, I don't get hit by focus, but what do I do now?
Yeah.
1 HP and, like, no cards, no resources.
Yeah.
You're still dead in the water. Yeah, and that's game. Kyle wants to take the
That's
set
game. That's it.
2-1.
That's it. Only a best of 3 this time. Calavant is now with his fourth tournament win in 2 tournaments against Mix.
Is it really? Oh yeah, it
Yeah.
is. Yeah,
Winners finals and grand finals last tournament, week 5 and grand finals this tournament.
Mix took one. He reset the bracket.
He
Judge
took
James.
several Oh yeah, 4-1. Then
Yeah.
4-1. I actually never saw that match, so I don't know. It never happened if I didn't see it.
Yeah, mix was it losers, reset the bracket because Calvados and Calvados won. Yeah.
The play knight being forced out is interesting.
It was cool to see. Definitely a much better fighting chance playing Plague Knight versus Umina than Hakumen. And yeah, Calvados is showing why he's the best Umina
It's a
in the
little bit tough though,
business.
right? Because like you can't say range one's tough, so you really only have that range two to stand at as Plague Knight.
Plague Knight range 2 is good, so it's fine.
We done here? I don't know. Yes.
Yeah, we're done.
I'm
We
done. Do
done.
you want it? I don't want to interview him. I don't care.
Oh,
Do you? I
you
guess
want?
should we do a winner's interview? I guess I
What do you
shouldn't say
think?
I don't care. I mean, I.
What do you want a winner's interview for your video?
Well, the thing is, if I'm doing the video, then I'm going to cut the part out where I said I don't care about the winner's interview.
Okay, says interview the man. Okay.
Right? I don't want to expose myself.
I will ask them.
If you want. Yeah, well, I would cut that part out. I would cut the part out. Yeah, I don't want to make myself look like that. All right, well, I guess they want to.
Yeah, let's talk to them.
All
To
right,
the
let's.
grand
All
finalists.
right, cut. I guess that cut was going to be like 5 minutes beforehand. All
Let's
right, never
join them.
mind.
Hey guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Great
Yeah, this
games.
is James.
Yeah, GG's. Migo has some interview questions prepared for
Oh
you.
yeah, sure.
No, I don't.
Go for it. I actually said on the video that I don't care about this interview, so I had to cut that part out.
Man, what do I even say? I haven't done an interview before.
Migo is streaming though, so he has to cater to his live audience, which is
Yeah.
actually all
Yo,
Calvontis fans.
what is Twitch chat asking for? What are we getting requested on?
Oh, okay. I guess we could ask Twitch chat. Do you have any questions for Calvontis or Mix here?
The two best players in Exceed.
Okay. First question from Winus YZZ. Who is your favorite fan, Calvontis? Because you have a
Who's
fan
my
club.
favorite fan?
You have a fan club in Twitch chat, so figure.
I'm not allowing this question. Veto. Next question. Sorry, guy. You
Right.
gotta drop a sub for to ask that kind of question.
You can't even sub to my
In a
channel.
stream?
Yeah, I know. That's the thing. You can't sub to Migos' channel, so your question's banned. Sorry, guy.
Who's your favorite fan, Calvatus?
My favorite fan.
Because you have a whole, like, at least three people supporting you right now.
That's.
In my eyes, everyone is equal. So, all my fans, I have the same amount of love, you know?
Ah, there you go.
I don't
You hear
know
it
if
here,
that's
folks.
like the most diplomatic way to approach
To
this.
be fair, there's only three of them, so.
You
Oh,
love all
wow.
three of them equally. That's good.
You love all three of them equally.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, question from Ashy the Great. I guess this
Is
question
this
applies
another
to
one of your
both of you
friends,
guys.
Calvontis?
They might be.
This
I
interview was a bad idea.
How did I prepare for this match?
Yeah, I guess this
I
can be applied
watched
to both
it.
players. Yeah, so let's start with Calvontis. How do you prepare for this
Well, yeah,
finals?
I mean, first of all, gotta get in shape. I hit the gym 6 times a week for
That's
six
true.
hours per
Get the
round.
games. Like
Get the right amount of sleep.
physical activity, unironically important.
Unironically
Kind
important,
of.
actually, it's
Unironically
PG
important.
monster. Like in this kind of game
Thank
when
you.
like Mix and I were like having like this battle of stamina, right? Mental stamina. Like it actually helps so much to just get like a
Yes.
good night's sleep, drink a lot of water,
Proper
take a little bit
diet.
of caffeine, just
Sorry,
like
I'm
get
gonna take over this interview question.
okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, proper diet, good sleep, exercise, three things. Also playing Exceed. That's like thing number four.
Oh
And
yeah,
it's like in this.
just play an absolute crap ton of Exceed,
Yeah.
Yeah, Calvatus does do be grinding those hours.
yeah, the grind. What can I say?
Nice. How about you, Mix? How do you prepare for these finals?
I played yesterday.
Oh, nice.
That was it.
That was it.
No
Damn.
diet, no water, no sleeping.
You didn't hit the gym as
I did
well.
sleep in today. Does that count?
There you go.
That counts.
That counts.
Think getting the most, like, a good amount of sleep is number one, or else your brain doesn't function. Solid.
I definitely didn't feel prepared this match, though.
Didn't feel prepared.
This felt more like a casual match where I'm inherently disfavored.
I see.
Inherently what?
Disfavored.
You think so? The you talking about the final AMU or the set as a whole?
The set.
Okay.
Okay, so you did feel like you have enough preparation against Calvontis' characters and such.
Yeah, I guess I didn't really try to prepare, so.
Fair enough. I know Calvontis was doing much more preparation against like Zolt and Hakumen.
Yeah, I watched it.
So he was. Yeah, he was trying to.
I mean, it's mostly just playing games. I don't think there's that much theory when it comes to Zolt. It's like
right.
Yeah, it's important to play the games to like remember.
Yeah.
Obscure interactions, right?
Yeah, I mean, just play the game and like anything to read any practice you do reduce your overhead costs. Like when it comes to like card counting, you know, like threat evaluation, Borsa evaluation, strike evaluation. Like the less it takes on your brain to process all that, like just stuff that can be automated. Like the better, the more resource you can dedicate to actually thinking about the overall strategy and like what your opponent wants to do, what you want to do. So
great answer, right? So it just makes all these things just second nature when you the more you play.
Yeah, like when you just play like enough games, like it becomes evident. And like you start to like think about things that you normally don't think about because you now have to like the, you know, the brain power to literally like actually like explore things that you haven't explored before. Like that's how I see it. You know, like I still think this game is. Like it's nowhere near like solved or anything, but like you know, like there's just substantial progress you can make in thinking about things out.
Yeah, that's a great deal. Like Exceed. I feel like the skill ceiling for this game is almost unlimited. Yeah. Almost.
Yeah. Like for that second game, I think I had like a slight out. Like I made a slight mistake where I don't know. It was I think it was position. I was cornered, right? It was like the second to last strike. It was pretty obvious he strike with like an advantage chain. Instead of playing the stun immune assault, I just wild swung for some reason. So I don't know.
I had the answer to the assault with cross up. My plan was if you play a thing, yeah, just grasp you and then cross up.
But
that's why I didn't cross up immediately.
Oh no, but
you can keep it for next time.
Just save it. I see.
Yeah, you can still assault it. Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. For that Zolt matchup, I feel like there was one turn that was pretty critical. If I just, instead of pairing a Mist, what was it? Is it your Blade
Mist, Firm? Mist Wild Hunt, and then I parried the Horse Mist.
If I just full space the Fatal Eye, that was like pretty big. Like it was just one or two actions that was different that would have made that game like significantly changed it. Overall, it was a good set. Like, I mean, Mix and I play a lot of the Zolt versus Umina, and I think there's like a meta between us that's been developed, and there's like a lot of thinking that goes into it.
I see. Just yeah. Two players.
Definitely true.
Yeah, because I was commenting like that match, that Zolt versus Umina match looked pretty dire. It was like you basically needed Hollow Space to basically try and win strikes clean.
Yeah, I had to land a parry somehow. At some point.
Looked very difficult.
There are some alternative lines, but that requires the proper decking, and it just depends on what you draw, really, to succeed.
I also got pretty lucky. I think I drew two EX transforms.
Yeah, you got both blades.
Turn one EX transform was lucky, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's Blaze of Fire, which is worse, but then I got Whip Quack, and it's like, okay.
Like,
you can pay, yeah, if you can pay my cross up, I don't care anymore. I can exceed now.
Yeah.
And that was also the turn where I boosted the ultra boost.
That force strike,
gave
right?
me basically gave me one gauge. That was also pretty huge.
Yeah.
So we're playing game of footies, trying to know each other's plays, and then I just do that. I just force him to give me gauge.
Yeah, the
so
the,
I can exceed. I can actually play the game now.
That movement between you guys was really cute.
It's cute.
The Zolt backing away one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Searching for my transforms.
Season 2.
It was very Season 2. Just like no players striking each other for like forever.
Yeah. What are you guys going to do with your immense amounts of cash that you've won?
Probably, you know, like order a plane ticket with Jeff Bezos and see where the space takes us.
You go to space, yeah.
Yeah? Yeah, that's for sure.
Fair.
Probably like some my winnings. Money, my venture capital funds, you know, like pay child support for my couple of my mistresses, you know, all that jazz.
Nice.
Yep. every other Tuesday, what can I say?
There you go. You can buy like 1/60th of a Tesla stock.
Wow.
It's pretty good.
I only got second place, so I can only buy a fighting game. I'm actually basically covering debt from buying Melty Blood.
Oh, I see.
That costs way too much, so I need to win a bunch of tournaments to cover that.
Yeah, makes sense.
Part of Ryan, what can we say?
I had a serious question, but I forgot it, so that's okay.
Nice.
That's fine. Questions.
I think I won $0. Sad, because I'm probably
up
just fourth.
$30 in Steam games in Yomi in
actually,
10 years
what is
of Yomi.
Wait, it says third place is $10, right? You should get $10 because you're second. Aren't you?
I think Wim is third place.
Or there is.
I think I asked Jungi what a third place is.
I didn't want to suggest a third place match because I didn't want Migo to fight God Wim again. I didn't want to subject him to that.
You're so kind.
So I didn't say anything. I kept my mouth shut.
Yeah. So
maybe they can share the lavish prize winnings.
Yeah. Maybe we can split the $10.
Yeah. You can get like a taco at Taco Bell.
Yeah. Huge. Let's see. Do you guys have any more questions in chat? I see people just praising Cal Vontis' brain power, that he has a STEM degree from Berkeley.
What is this?
Wow.
Just praising what a...
Apparently, I was playing in Cal's home turf. Okay, I see how that is.
Yeah, yeah.
Well,
unfortunately,
you're
Cal Vontis had the home field advantage.
No, okay. So in all seriousness, like, the three people in chat, they literally do not play Exceed, so, like, they're just here for more support. In all seriousness, they just know that it's, like... You know that... That guy Catavantes, yeah, in our friend group, yeah, I think he plays some kind of tournament, and I'm like, oh yeah, I do, and, you know, like.
I see.
Well, this game, I heard he's pretty good.
Bring
this game,
your posse next time around.
Yeah, I forgot to call my posse.
You forgot. You forgot to call him up.
Yeah, get those EU gang in here. And,
yeah.
You know, have some
EU mafia,
jump
dude.
Match.
Yeah, you get the EU mafia. Yeah. Oh, actually,
you know who they are, amigo.
Actually, the great claims to play Exceed, so there you go. Just one person in your fan club that plays this game.
Yikes.
That's pretty good. I mean, I don't play Exceed, so that's like the same.
Wait, why are you here? Get out of the room.
I'm pretty sure you played more Exceed than he did.
I am.
Why are you even here in the first place?
Full-time commentator.
Uh-huh, yeah.
/ card UI designer.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Oh, yes.
End of the day, it's just like a fun little community thing, right? Like.
Yeah. I sincerely enjoy watching Exceed and theorizing about it more than I enjoy playing it.
Yeah.
That's fair.
That goes for a lot of games.
Yeah.
To be honest.
There's plenty of armchair gamers that just like talking about a game or looking at it.
Yeah.
It do be like that.
Is pretty good to actually play, though.
Yeah, this is honestly one of the better design games. Like, I keep saying this. I really feel like it's very elegant. Like, it's perfect balance between like casual and like depth. I feel like that's
Exceed is a really good game to introduce. It's a very good to pick up and play and teach new players. Yeah. And then there's plenty of depth to this game. Yeah.
And hopefully in a month we get some preview of the next season, season 6. You know.
Season 6.
Yeah, in a year maybe.
In 2026. Yeah.
I'm literally like.
I'm at limit
with all these characters.
Yeah, I played plenty of season 5. I played so many of these characters. Yeah, it's just like I'm at my limit. I need more content. I need season 6. They said January, so hopefully, yeah.
Did they?
I think so.
They said
likely January. I think
that's all speculations. They just said next year. Everyone's like, well, next year it has to be January.
Next year starts
there
January
year,
1st.
You know, like...
If I don't get my Exceed announcement when the ball drops. Yeah, there's a cat on Plague Knight's deck. Did you know that? Does Plague Knight have a cat?
Oh, that's so cute.
It's horrible.
So cute.
I guess.
Oh, yeah,
that's pretty extensive lore, because there's a whole game about him. I don't know it, though. I just know Funny Man Explosions.
Funny Man Explosions, yeah. Wacky scientists.
Yeah. That's all.
Oh yeah, CPAT was really happy that you played Plague Knight, Nyx. So
I was so hype. I love Plague Knight, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
the coolest.
I mean, the theory was that Hakumen does not do well against Umina, so you
pitch. So him. I gotta bring someone else.
No, the pick was smart.
I had to try him. I had to try him. I'm not gonna. If I play Hakumen and then I lose, it feels like. Yeah, you just why am I here? This is literally just a run back to the previous tournament.
You're like doing the same thing. Yeah, exactly. You gotta try
something. There's no reason to do this. So this feels better. This matchup is worse though. This matchup's horrible. If Umina doesn't succeed, you just automatically lose. So there's nothing you can do against Hollow Space. There's actually nothing. And then she has so many answers, and she just can't. She can't do anything.
Yeah,
it was a big mistake on my part.
She had the sending me an assault, and I'm like, I have no answers to that. Cornered. You can just corner yourself. Have sending me an assault. Nothing I can do. Actually, nothing I can do. Because every time I threaten Spike, everything loses to the stun and super assault. And so, you know, you can always play block or stun me assault, and I can't do anything. And of course, as you saw, he can just boost Dream Telling and hit me with stun me assault.
It's a 9 power, or 8 power,
What is this? Fun card, right?
Fun
boost. It's the classic Umina, which works against players opponents with no defensive cards, which is playing on it, right? Because I mean
your crosses were down the first reshuffle pretty early.
That's kind of true, yeah.
Yeah, so I was just it's just free damage, literally nothing you can do about.
Yep.
Not many answers.
Yeah, I got greedy after that. I was like, I have a billion gauge. I have so much damage dealt in. I should exceed and try to finish the game. But no, that was just kind of giving you like a way out. Could just.
Yeah. I had to literally wild swing into every fucking answer. I had to wild swing into both blocks and then like just keep wild swinging and keep winning mix ups. Yeah. And until you deck out. That's like the only win condition I have left. Because I'm like, through my entire deck, you have 20 life. There's no way I can deal 20 damage. Because you're Mina.
Yeah. That was tough. So I remember during the end, I was just like, okay, here's a very specific answer, but he needs to top deck this and have these two cards in hand to discard. It's just like, this is not happening.
Yeah, I had two dives in hand, but I mean, one dive hit the fucking chain reaction. That's so bad.
Mm-hmm.
And then I top deck another chain reaction.
Yeah.
It was looking very desperate.
I didn't need to wild swing so many times successfully.
Yeah.
So he has 6 gauge, and so every time he hits, he gets a gauge back, and so that's like 6 wild swings, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was the right play to have go down the hand size at the end, like not preparing, because what's the point of prepping when I'm just gonna
force the
wild swing to break, like... Yeah, it was interesting.
I need to keep... I need to keep a threat, like... That was because I need to do something on my turn. Moving is not it. Moving does nothing because you have your move one take another action.
Exactly.
So I can't. There's nothing I can actually do. And so, but the only relevant movement I did was when I moved out of the corner that I could cross to dodge some stuff. But then you know, top deck assault. Yeah, just media things, right? There's nothing you can actually do.
I actually didn't realize how good slipping away was for Exceed Umina.
Yes, slipping away.
It's insane. Moving more than taking another action is ridiculous. On every single character. This is why Hasma works, right?
Yeah. It's like literally if you don't have that, like I'm inclined not to exceed unless I can get that transformation out. It's just like half your power budget on the exceed side, I feel like.
Comes from that transformation.
The other half is terrorist puzzle.
Yeah. That's like for any Umina enjoyers.
Use your range for free is never not gonna be good.
Yeah, action compression. It's just so nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, what else?
But yeah,
because you get a lot of force.
Oh yeah, I guess in this tournament, I picked a Bane. That was a pretty meta changer. I guess it was just pretty dominant in most of the games.
Yeah. Did you lose at Bane?
I unfortunately lost against Migo's Jin as Bane. Yeah. And
Jin, my boy.
I have 100% win rate on either characters.
Imagine playing Exceed and not even having a 100% win rate.
It's unfortunate. What can I say? What are their win rates right now?
What's the next character that Calvantis brings to the meta? I guess is the question.
I mean, like if I'm not bringing Bane, I'm inclined to go for someone like I don't know what's left in season 5. Rachel, 9, Hosman, like those are the kind of characters I enjoy.
Yeah, 9 is the most unexplored character right now.
Bring 9, yeah.
9 is also like a lot like a similarity in like macro playstyle with Umina. So like that is kind of in my like that's kind of in my like field of play. But I've been trying to avoid nine for quite some time for now, because I mean, like, can't really bring her out in casuals. No one wants to really play against the nine. But might have to if there's like another tournament, just might look at that.
I think there are like plans for another. I don't know if they will come into fruition, but
yeah, we'll see how people like, you know.
I'm more interested to see in tournaments if anyone can take you guys down.
Just play more games. What can I say? That's your best chance.
There you go. To all the Calavantis fans out there not playing Exceed.
Oh yeah.
Maybe it could be
just,
one of
just
you.
Okay.
Maybe
it could be you. That's how you beat Zolt. And then I don't know, get a good matchup against Hakuman. There's a bunch of them there.
Or yeah. would you be switching characters to mix now that you've gotten second place twice?
Would I be switching characters? Yes, I would not bring Plague Knight. I would bring whatever character heart counters me the most.
We have to cut that part out because you said you're not bringing Plague Knight, so
disappointment.
I mean you could always bring like just like Renee or Minato and pick those characters. I mean, I can't really beat like
Non-season 2.
Non-season 2.
I only call myself one season 2 character, and that has to be Zolt. Otherwise, I only play season 2. Am I really playing Exceed if I only play season 2? Like, no.
I will say I'm glad that you took out the Renea toys. It's nice to see. Oh god.
Thank you for beating Renea players. Thank you. Renea players.
The Hakuman versus Renea definitely is underrated character versus... Well, I guess overrated, but like she's super broken. Yeah. So correctly rated.
Yeah.
I mean, she can't be underrated, right? So
no way. Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah. She can't be under. What else? Yeah, Bang is Bang's performance was nice. I don't know if I'm gonna go back to him. That's the issue.
It seems like you've like explored a lot of alliances with Bang already.
I'm just like, I was really surprised about his ability to take on some season 2 characters. I think that's pretty big.
His matchup against Zolt is pretty decent.
Yeah, finding the right timings and all.
Yeah, that was.
Now we're talking about like these strategies after we talk about the garbage ass interview question.
Listen, like, you gotta blame Migo for the interview. I've said it.
I just asked chat what they wanted. Yeah.
There's proof that no interview was requested by me. It's your fans, really, that wanted the interview.
They wanted it to happen. There's no way they asked for an interview.
You can look at the Twitch chat. Yeah.
Right, I'll have to look back.
Ooh, you asked for the interview. You said, "Are we done here?" Oh, Migo said, "Want to come in for an interview?"
Yeah,
so.
I didn't request. I mean, okay, maybe I opened the line of.
You opened the
like,
line.
Request.
I was about to flip the table and close the room.
Wait, people, no, I mean, like, wow. It's a grand final, so I don't know if we're donezo or what. So
I mean, I can flip the table. Would we want that? The only thing is, if I flip the table, it might crash my OBS.
Well, that'd be a perfect way to end it.
And if it crashes my OBS, then it's gone. So let's not do that. I should flip a table for like one of the earlier, for like one of the pools matches to test the waters.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you can blame Migo for the garbage interview questions.
No,
fine. Yeah, I mean,
this is great. I don't know, like it doesn't need to have interview questions. We just talked a bunch about.
Yeah, it's like a podcast.
Game the characters, right?
Podcast.
Yeah, it's just a goon.
An Exceed podcast. That's the new meta. That's the new meta.
Yeah, that's what this is.
Episode
right?
One.
Yeah, podcast with this first episode. Yeah.
Throw out Pookie versus the world. We'll have this instead.
Oh, I was wondering.
Mix, not playing Exceed, so yeah.
I played Exceed 2 days ago, Mix.
Who did you play?
Yeah, but Will
played
play
my boy TK Treasure Knight.
I don't believe you.
I played TK. I played TK.
Name one of his specials.
Anchor Launch. Boom.
Special Muzzle too.
Anchor Launch is fine, fair, good joke. Scuttle Slam. I remember it because it's garbage.
Wow.
There you go.
Okay,
Dive Charge. Boom. I named like half of them. 3 out of 5. That's pretty good. I don't remember. Yeah, I don't remember the other two.
You could all tap back to the back away from the Google now.
Yeah, I know. Dude, it's recorded. It's recorded. I don't remember the other two specials.
All right.
Okay, yeah, wait, hold on. I got a deafen so I can do a proper exit.
What is it? It's like, isn't it like treasure coin or something like that? And
treasure coin? Oh, yes, yeah. That's one of his specials.
Yeah, and
what is the last one?
Did I actually forget about the other one?
Yeah,
I did.
Dive charge?
Aquamine.
Oh, Aquamine, there we go, yeah.
There
and
we go.
And Maelstrom Pulse, I think is the Maelstrom.
Yeah, Maelstrom Chest and Angler Call.
Nice. We're all Treasure Knight players here.
We have Master Treasure
Knight.
But yeah, congrats to you guys and to Remiki this far.
Thanks for casting.
Yeah. It was really up to date finals.
Now you can be off the record and swear whatever you want to do because the video's over.
Oh, I think we're wrapping this up.
I'm gonna meet up with Kala after we're done here, and then we're gonna split the money, right? Right, Kala, that's how we.
Oh, it was a collusion, right? Yeah, you guys are gonna split the prize money.
$25 prize pool. Yeah,
$25 prize pool.
Quite the interest.
I'm only doing this because I actually don't remember what the other two names are. Which oh,
renamed them while you were gone.
Treasure coin, and I named these Aquamine. I didn't draw Aquamine. So
I probably drew High Tide instead.
I did not. No, I did not. Whoa. I boosted this like 3 times.
That's unlucky.
I boosted this and then like returned it.
I did not draw Aquamine and still reshuffle. Well, okay. I guess I can't say anything because
you know why? Because I didn't remember the card existed, so I didn't know what it did.
Fair. Imagine not knowing every single card in your deck. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, because I didn't want the game to last an hour, so I didn't like look. Oh. I didn't set up references.
But you're playing Treasure Knight.
Yeah, dude. This card's broken enough. Who needs this? This card's good enough.
Yeah, I could probably name all of Jin's.
And then just like returning with this. This
yeah,
is it.
Yeah, it's really good.
Boom. That's how I won. I took 10 damage though, because I wild swung a sweep into a spike, and then I wild swung a focus from one of the Ignore Armor cards. I don't remember the name.
Who are you playing against?
I was playing against Prop.
Oh, Cannonball.
Cannonball.
Yep. Cannonball.
Okay, I think that's it for the stream. We gotta. I think we should call it here. It's a good point. Stop.
Yeah, I've already cut the video. Yeah, so now's a good time to stop for you.
Chad's requesting a table flip to send us off.
Okay, I can do it now.
Ready?
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Oh.
Nice. All right, just
amazing.
Oh, well, that's disappointing.
Yeah.
Fuck you, CPAC.
Direct chat.
God, I hate you so much.
You're not my chat.
Okay. Congrats to both players. Well played to Calvantis and Mix. Congrats to winning another tournament, Calvantis. You deserve it because you're like, the best in the game.
Can anybody stop this man?
No one can stop him.
No.
We managed to land wounds on him, but we can't bring him down. Too powerful.
There's always next time. What can I say?
There's always next time.
Yep.
Until I enter a tournament, Calvantis cannot be stopped.
Yeah, see, Pal will be the one to beat him. Totally.
Yeah, so. Yep. Definitely can happen.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it with Plague Knight, too. My boy, PK. No, I
good luck.
I'm bringing 3 top tier season 2s, dude. Imagine trying to interact with this game.
I will teach you the ways of Zolt if you want.
Dude, Zolt's easy.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I'm teaching.
It's easy. You just got to teach me the names of the cards. You just got to teach me the names of the cards.
I got to teach you Seeing Red and how to read Seeing Red.
I already know how to play Renea and I know how to play Remulus.
Well, they're both easy.
Well,
kind of easy. Yeah.
Remulus is pretty easy.
Maybe not that easy.
Once you know, I mean, I guess Remulus is easy to play like well enough, right?
At a passable level, yeah. Both Renea and Remulus are fall under that category of if you know like
too lazy.
No, but it's much easier.
Yeah.
I am too lazy to cut this video.
Alrighty.
Did you end your stream already?
No, it's still going. But okay, time to end the stream now. Alright.
The Calvantis. Sorry to the Calvantis fanboys that didn't get the table flip. I misclicked.
Yeah.
Oh, that was totally a misclick. How did you misclick?
Well, really? I aimed for the flip button, and then I accidentally hit the close game button. So what can you do?
What? But it's not even the close.
He's lying. My eyesight's bad.
C-pad.
My eyesight's
but
bad.
It's not close. It's not even. It's in the menu.
It also takes like 3 clicks to exit the game. So.
Yeah. How the fuck? Okay.
Wait. Who was on red side? Mix was on red side.
Yes, I was.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm just asking that because, like, I made 2 thumbnails, and I put red side on the left and a blue side on the right. Okay.
Gotcha.
All right.
Actual production value.
Nice.
Wow.
Actual production value.
You're a godsend, man. I don't know who else would be doing this, but.
Not Migo.
Yeah, I'm so lazy with thumbnails. I don't make them fancy.
I mean, the thumbnails is all I've got going for me because I don't really do analysis too well. So,
yeah, that's what you need. That's why you brought me on.
Yeah. I kind of need it as a crutch, you know. Cookies, drapes, returns, grand finals.
All right, chat. Thanks for everyone stopping by and watching the stream.
All right, sorry for insulting you more. Over and over again, chat. That's my bad. I'm not sorry, but I do acknowledge that it happened.
Uh huh. Totally.
I do acknowledge that it happened. There. I think that's a fair statement to make.
Yeah. Well, next time I might stream more Exceed without this goober here, CPAT. All right.
Nice. Good.
Thanks for stopping by, everyone. That was a fun grand finals. Peace.
Yep.